the renewal of one of the great rivalries in the history of the WWE, Cena versus Orton.
Orton got to know this could be his last chance at the WWE Championship.
Remember the rules of this matchup. Pinfalls or submission only. There won't be countouts, no disqualifications. Look at Randy Orton. Randy Orton perhaps trying to find a way out. And what a difference a padlock and a logging chain can make, as Randy Orton just found out.
Well,
quickly on the attack.
Just as Orton said, you don't know what he's capable of. Did he just sucker John Cena outside and then back in to catch the advantage on Cena?
Well, perhaps the Viper did just that.
Orton capable of anything.
Remember, King, as we saw earlier on, this is a different cell than we've experienced in the past. This is a reinforced Hell in a Cell. It's designed now to keep people inside. New bracing, new support, so different from the cells we've seen in the years past. Don't think Randy Orton does not know that. Randy Orton, what is his strategy after Big King against John Cena?
Well, strategy, a lot of strategy goes out the window when you're inside that cell. I mean, you just literally have to inflict as much.
Hey, look at the adjustment. Whoa! Look at the attitude adjustment. John Cena trying to connect Randy Orton. Managing to slither off the shoulders of Cena. Scoop slam by Orton. Remember, pinfall or submission, the only way to win. Orton into the pinfall. Here's the cover. Did he get it? No, a kick out at two by Cena.
And I have to think that the strategy of Orton and John Cena has to be use your ally. At some point in this match, you got to use your ally, and your ally, or can be your worst enemy, is that cage, that steel cell.
King, we do know this, that the demented and unbalanced Randy Orton has had weeks to try to figure out a strategy and how to use this cell as a weapon. We have ended Cena. Orton, though, sensed it coming. These two superstars know each other so well. What an amazing atmosphere here tonight. Ooh, and there is the first use of the cell as a weapon for either man in this match, with the WWE Championship on the line. This is where Orton becomes so dangerous.
Yep. Cena in a bad spot right now, out near that cell.
Randy with absolutely no absence of malice. Now look at how Orton's using the cell to his advantage. Getting himself a little more height to drop his 250-pound frame under the ribs of Cena.
Like we said, it can be your ally if you use it. Right now it's John Cena's second worst enemy. Look at, oh man.
Here's Cena at 2,700 square feet of chain link fence. A human, flesh grater.
Listen to our WWE Universe so into this match.
It is a big fight deal here, isn't it?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. You can't, if you're Cena or if you're Orton, you can't worry about trying to win the popularity contest. You got to worry about, you got to worry about defeating your opponent, and you got to worry about this Hell in a Cell.
And look at Cena.
Yeah.
Oh. Punishing Orton. Here is the power and strength of John Cena. Oh.
2,700 square feet of chain link.
Oh, yeah. An Orton counter. And Cena shoulder first off the steel steps, and suddenly it is advantage to the challenger Orton.
Yeah, that steel chain link, but you can't forget the steel steps inside there.
Randy Orton said that one of the things that he respects about John Cena, King, is Cena's power. So Orton, of course, with a game plan, to try to neutralize the power. Randy Orton back to the MO from breaking point to torture
Cena. His head kicked from behind, face first, right into that steel step. Before that, his wrist. I don't know. Oh, this is bad. All legal in this match. What is Randy Orton? This guy is so devious.
Well, the problem with Orton King is, you know, Randy Orton is an example of how heavy those steps are. The problem with Randy Orton King is that he's so demented, he's heartless, which makes his assaults even more. I mean, this guy's no emotion for anybody, no care for anybody.
He is without a doubt one of the most dangerous men in the history of the WWE.
You can almost see the wheels turning.
Exactly. I mean, you know, you talk about strategy. I don't know. I mean, I don't know if Randy Orton sits around and thinks about what am I going to do once I get in that match, or if it's just coming to him as he goes along.
Well, he's a third generation superstar. His family's been in the industry nearly 100 years. So I'm sure a lot of it does come natural for him.
Right, and he's an opportunist. I mean, he just does it as he goes.
No, not this, not this. This is premeditated. Orton thought this out. Oh, no. Oh, and Cena countered. The strength of Cena.
Well, he may have saved himself there.
You ain't kidding. They saved this match probably.
Yeah. And Orton launched out of the ring. Not only saved the match, he might have saved his health, his career. Orton was intending to DDT John Cena into those steel steps. Steps earlier, the hands of Orton.
You can only imagine what would have happened. This match would probably be over right now had Orton hit that move. Now what's Cena got in mind?
Look at this. Oh, no.
What
on earth is John Cena going to do here? You got to be kidding me.
Look out, Randy Orton.
You got to be kidding me. And Randy Orton.
Good grief.
Like I say, it's a good thing Orton ducked out of the way.
Good thing, that's the understatement of the century.
And look at John Cena. Building momentum, back on the attack, realizes Orton's been wounded. For a moment, and there's Orton!
Striking, like that cobra.
And Orton crawls to the cover. He hooks the leg this time for the championship, and a kick out by the champion at two.
Watch this. This would have been the end. That could have been the end of Randy Orton, as we know him.
And remember, King, there really is no advantage to the champion in this type of matchup because there are no countouts or disqualifications.
You're right, and that's why even the use of those big steel steps by John Cena was all legal.
Orton methodical. Trademark of Randy Orton. Measuring Cena, looking to strike at the most opportune moment.
Oh, it's Cena!
And Cena trying to build a head of steam. Here comes Cena.
This is what Orton did not need. Can you feel it, Michael? The momentum has changed. John Cena with a "you can't see me" message to Randy Orton. And now a five knuckle shuffle.
Well, this is the one thing that Orton could ill afford, is for John Cena to get on the roll he is on now. Going for the attitude adjustment, and Orton makes it to the ropes. And Randy Orton with a counter. How dangerous is Orton?
So resourceful. Can never, ever count Randy Orton out of anything.
And Randy Orton now setting up Cena. No steel steps this time. But it may not matter.
And he did.
Face first DDT as Orton goes for the WWE Championship. Once said, it is all he exists for is the title.
Orton's still reeling, still hurting. He may have enough here. Cover.
Throwing again on the champion. John Cena in trouble. Has to power out at two again. We saw a desperate look on the face of Cena when he powered out. Viper coiling. Look at the eyes. He is about to explode.
He wants to deliver that RKO.
And if he does, he may win the championship.
The Viper is about to strike. Look out, John! No!
Cena countered the RKO! Going for the attitude adjustment! And he connects! John Cena! Hooks the leg! Two count! Got him! No! And a kick out by Orton! He kicked out!
Are you sure? Yes, the referee is explaining to John Cena that Orton got his shoulder up just in the nick of time. Unbelievable.
But what's so devastating for Cena, King, is he kicked out after the attitude adjustment did Orton.
You're right. Cena hits Orton with his best shot. Look at the disbelief. The look of disbelief on the face of John Cena.
Well, John Cena, I firmly believe, knew in his mind after the attitude adjustment he was going to win this match. And Randy Orton did not allow it to happen.
Back to the drawing board now for Cena. It's like, what do we got to do?
Cena.
I don't know where Cena's going here.
We don't see Cena go climb the ropes much. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Cena thinking an attitude. Of,
well, the first one didn't work from the mat. Maybe this one will work and Randy Orton countered.
I think Cena was thinking attitude and just went onto the floor. Now look out.
Inside Hell in a Cell. And Randy Orton could be closing in on another reign as champion. And again, a kick out. And that time, it was a desperate look in the face of Orton. What does he need to do to win the title?
I think Orton, you know, he's got to be thinking RKO. He just hasn't had the opportunity to hit it.
Well, the problem inside Hell in a Cell, too, is the match can turn just like that. Oh, as I mentioned earlier, 5,700 square feet of chain link. And again, Randy Orton methodically picking apart Cena. Seems like every time Cena gets some momentum going, Orton just counters.
Well. Orton trying to pull Cena up. Are you thinking superplex, maybe?
Well, going to the top rope was not successful for Cena earlier. Will it be more successful for Orton?
Cena fighting, trying to keep Orton from getting the position he needs to suplex Cena off that top.
Again, just tremendous willpower by John Cena to do all he can.
And Cena wins that test of strength.
Test of wills as well.
Oh, look at what's John doing here. Look at this!
Went for the leg drop to the back of the neck. John Cena looked to put Orton away there. And again, Orton manages to avoid near disaster.
You were so right early on, Michael. These two men know. I think they know what the other man is thinking before they execute a move. It's like, I read your book.
Uh-oh. Again, that steel chair, legal as a weapon in this match. You gotta win via pinfall or submission. What a better way to get a pinfall than by knocking out your opponent.
John realizes that chair's in the ring.
Orton's dangerous enough without a weapon.
Oh, no. Cena's neck. Wait a minute.
Cena just a year removed from neck surgery.
Did you drive that into the back of John's neck?
I believe so. Will the championship reign be over for Cena? And a kick out at two. He's got issues.
Oh, the demons inside his head are raging.
Randy Orton is just twisted. What is he doing?
I don't know. I don't know if he knows what he's doing. Other than,
this is what Orton's doing. Randy Orton, who loves to stomp his opponent. Physical as well as psychological, takes so much out of your opponent when Randy Orton does this.
How much punishment can John Cena take?
Well, the fact there's a steel chair under his skull doesn't help matters any. Oh, and it's Randy Orton, though, who goes knee first into the chair.
Orton was going to deliver a devastating knee drop with Cena's head on the chair. Now look at Cena go.
John Cena going for the STF. Going for the STF, and he has it locked in. John Cena with the STF locked in. Will he get Randy Orton to tap out? If he does, he retains the title. Orton trying to crawl to the ropes.
Orton has quit before.
But if Orton gets to the ropes, it won't matter. There will be no break if he makes it to the ropes. He's got to get out of this STF on his own.
The referee says no. That's not in this match, Randy.
And a little unorthodox here in the STF as well, as John Cena's got the right leg wrapped.
Look at Orton. Listen.
What are you saying, Orton? You want to give it up? You want to give it up?
Orton has the bottom rope is stopping John Cena, but now he's driving
for a moment. For a moment, and now Randy Orton hits the counter as the referee goes down. And John Cena right back on the attack again. Looks for the STF, and he's in. It's locked in. The STF is locked in. And John Cena, and look at Orton's tapping. Orton's tapping out. Randy Orton's tapping. But the official was knocked down. Never saw it.
Did it? I don't know. The referee is actually outside the ring here. The referee knocked through the ropes as a result of that collision with Randy Orton, and Cena may realize that the referee does not know that Orton tapped out.
Randy Orton
did tap, didn't he?
Tapped out clear as day. Strikes with an RKO. The cover hooks the leg.
No,
will
no,
win.
No.
Will be the new champion.
No.
He's got him. Randy Orton's got him.
John Cena powers out.
Almost in tears.
I think Orton is about to cry.
That may have been Orton's last chance. STF, which worked on the right leg later on. But Randy Orton.
Oh, Randy Orton is.
Now Cena left.
Oh, he's tied Cena's arms into the rope. Cena's in a helpless position here.
Cena's defenseless.
Choke Cena out!
Look at Cena. The referee's helpless.
He's
because
look at this.
It's all legal.
Look at Cena's head. face, turning blood red. Cena's arms and shoulders locked in those ropes. He's helpless.
John Cena is knocked out here, passes out his crown of new champion.
Oh, but Cena's head is locked into the vice-like grip of Orton. Is it over?
Cena is unresponsive.
He moved his hand. The referee looks as the referee helps get Cena released from those ropes, but
Cena was defenseless. He had no way of defending himself. This is a really dangerous spot to be in for John Cena. For all the damage and destruction Randy Orton has caused in the past.
Well, I thought Orton had Cena choked out.
See the expression change?
What's he thinking?
Look, that's what he's thinking! A punch to the skull! He kicks in and got him!
Randy Orton is the new WWE Champion!
WWE Champion, Randy Orton!
You know what was scary about that whole sequence at the end, King? You saw Randy Orton, when he was in the corner, his expression changed. It's almost like a light bulb went on in his head.
Yeah, it's like we talked about earlier. These things just come to Cena as they happen. And I can't believe this.
For the sixth time, Randy Orton's a world champion. The new WWE Champion, Randy Orton.
I would have bet my house on John Cena. I cannot believe what we've just witnessed.
This isn't over until I say it's over.
Drew McIntyre still has hell to pay.
My title and my legacy on the line, I'm not sending you to purgatory.
WWE title inside the demonic hell in a cell.
Hell. The following contest is a Hell in a Cell match, and it is for the Raw Women's Championship. Introducing first the challenger from the Queen City, Charlotte. Her opponent from Boston, Massachusetts, she is the Raw Women's Champion, Sasha Banks.
And the trash talk has begun. Both these women have held that championship on two different occasions. Sasha took the title from Charlotte on Raw a number of weeks ago in Los Angeles, and now it'll start to sink in for both Charlotte and Sasha Banks. The 20-foot-high, 5-ton structure slowly being lowered to the floor.
You know, I can't help but think of the cryptic words of General Manager Mick Foley during the contract signing between these two ladies, where he said, listen, this cell has no soul. This cell has no conscience. I want you to believe in your hearts that you are prepared for how this will impact your career.
Guys, you can see the emotion on both of these women's faces, how much this opportunity means to them. I think it's all sinking in.
Charlotte blindsiding Sasha Banks. Charlotte blindsiding the boss, and this match hasn't even started yet.
The cell's not even down.
I was going to say it might get crushed by the cell.
Yeah, thank goodness they stopped the cell on its way down. The official's out there. Charlotte with a sneak attack on Sasha. The match isn't even underway.
Just goes to show you guys how badly the Queen wants to reclaim her throne.
Oh, we've seen this before, Corey. We know that Charlotte will have no hesitation to try to injure Sasha Banks.
Neither will Sasha as she sends Charlotte out of the WWE Universe. And now Sasha with a kick right to the spine.
Now how fitting the backdrop, her hometown, defending the Women's Championship in the crowd.
Yeah, but can the boss handle the pressure of being in her own town?
And again,
defending
guys,
her championship in a historic match.
Well, she's not defending anything right now because the match hasn't even started yet. This is just a brawl. The bell never rang. Charlotte sneak attacks Sasha. Now the battle's out in the crowd. Never expected the match to start, well, this event to start this way as Charlotte's tossed back into the ringside area.
It looks like the cell has been completely pulled down here. Both these ladies will have to enter through the door, but that's the last thing on their mind right now.
And Sasha, she's gonna send Charlotte a message. You wanna mess with me, you don't mess with the boss.
Sasha trying to prevent it. Charlotte's still climbing, and now Sasha is too.
This is nuts. Look at Sasha. Charlotte teetering.
Charlotte able to break her own fall somewhat. What's the button?
Well, Sasha trying to make it down off the cell. Oh my goodness, Charlotte. Sasha's in trouble. Charlotte's got Sasha. Sasha trying to fall out of this. Through a table.
Watch this table explode with the boss's body. What impact.
Has powerbombed Sasha to the table, yet this match really hasn't officially started.
The official forcing Charlotte off him as he checks on Sasha Banks. The champion is in deep, deep trouble, and to Byron's point, this match isn't even underway.
Sasha,
this is a brawl.
Sasha's body is absolutely mangled.
And this is a shame.
Sasha just struggling just to stand.
WWE fans trying to get Charlotte and get Sasha back into this.
I don't think Sasha needs the WWE Universe. She's a doctor.
The official's doing a nice job keeping Charlotte away from the boss, but Sasha. Charlotte saying, ring the bell.
Charlotte trying to rub it in the face of Sasha's hometown crowd.
Sasha can't even stand up straight. Charlotte just mocking Sasha. Stand up.
Sasha Banks' lower back continues to give out. She can barely support her own body weight. There's no way she's gonna be able to compete in a match.
The official asking for a doctor to come down now and check on Charlotte. As she turned the corner, she just collapsed.
This is Sasha. The expression on her face says it all.
The
You know, opinions aside, it absolutely sucks to see this happen. I mean, both of these women were so looking forward to this match, this history-making match, and now Sasha's not even going to be able to compete.
Well, Charlotte's the only one to blame. Now the audacity of Charlotte to get in the ring now and gloat.
Oh, no.
The doctor's taking every precaution here, neck brace being put in place. I hate to see this.
This is certainly not the night that Sasha Banks envisioned having for herself.
This was, you know, supposed to be the perfect homecoming for Sasha.
What does Charlotte get out of this now?
If Sasha Banks can't compete, right. If Sasha can't defend her title, I mean, you need a new women's champion.
Well, again, Corey, let's keep in mind, though, the match never officially started. It wasn't like the match started and then this happened and the champion couldn't continue. The match never started.
It doesn't matter. If you're not here to be the women's champion, you're going to be replaced. Who better than Charlotte?
Well, right now we just need to be concerned about the health of Sasha Banks. This is beyond the championship right now.
And just a pathetic display by Charlotte.
You can't be surprised. I mean, the emotions between these two have been boiling over. You can't be surprised that Charlotte lost her cool, but to this extent, it's unfortunate.
Imagine Sasha's mom and her family just watching this scene.
Ladies
take
and
place.
Gentlemen, unfortunately, Sasha Banks is unable to compete. Therefore, here is your winner due to forfeit and the new Raw.
Wait a minute, the official just waved off the announcement by JoJo. Oh, and Sasha Banks is off the.
The boss is on the stretcher. Sasha can barely stand. You can't compete.
Well, Charlotte wants the title, but she's not going to get it without earning it.
I think as soon as Sasha heard that announcement, she just filled with emotion. She couldn't let it go down.
And Sasha told the official, ring the bell. And here we go. Hell in a Cell underway. What does Sasha have left? Charlotte looking to attack the champion. Sasha going to bring Charlotte outside the ring. And Sasha's.
Sasha can barely stand and now trying to defend the women's championship in the biggest match of her life.
And the boss looking to take out Charlotte early. A relentless attack by the boss, infuriated. Charlotte trying to run away. She wants out. She wants out of the cell.
Yeah, no escape now, Queen.
Charlotte did not envision this happening. Sasha Banks firing back.
I believe in Sasha's mind. She's thinking, I've worked too hard, too long to lose it like this.
Oh my goodness.
Face first off the post.
Sasha might just have lost a few teeth.
See her eyes roll back in her head there. She fell to the floor.
Goes back to my point. It's brave by Sasha Banks. Sure, everybody's excited, but is it smart? Is Sasha in any condition to compete on the highest level with Charlotte?
Well, Sasha trying to use her emotion. And back first into the cell. Charlotte weathered that early emotional storm by Sasha. And now the official again checking on the champion.
And now the queen can reevaluate and pick apart the champion at will.
Sasha was going on flat out adrenaline. Remember, she was powerbomb through the announce table, covered by Charlotte, hook of the leg here and a kick out. Then she was just sent into the cell, and now Charlotte knees to the back. The challenger. Watch this.
A monkey flip. Charlotte using those amazingly powerful legs to launch the boss right on her head. Watch this. First the cell,
and
then
the
her
back.
Head.
Oh.
And to your point, Corey, it's not smart for Sasha to compete in this match, but Sasha's been in this situation before where she lost that women's championship after only a couple weeks. She didn't want to experience that taste of bitterness in her mouth again.
I guarantee you right now, Sasha Banks feels like she's been in a car wreck.
I'll take one more look. Sasha is launched into the cell.
First the cell, then almost her whole body weight coming back on her neck. And
again, right there in the left hand corner of your screen, Charlotte attacking the back once again for the championship and a kick out.
Take another look back while we were in a replay. Look at the power, the absolute raw power by Charlotte, launching the boss spine first into the turnbuckle.
And what you're also seeing now is the confidence, the growing confidence of Charlotte in this match.
You know, it's somewhat ironic that the most damage in this match so far happened outside of Hell in a Cell, even before the match began. The power bomb through the announce table. And now Charlotte looks to take advantage. Sasha lands, though, on her feet. Oh, looking for the bank statement.
Oh.
Bank statement. Bank statement on Charlotte. Is Charlotte going to tap? And Charlotte, though,
just too powerful.
Yeah. And now launching Sasha. Oh, the top rope again. And her back caught the apron on the way to the floor. I think the back issue said some problem could have hurt Sasha as she tried to lock in the bank statement.
Yeah, absolutely. There's no way Sasha could get the power that she needed for that submission. But watch this. Just unceremoniously dumping Sasha Banks first onto the apron, then the floor.
Charlotte knows that every impact, every blow is going to be excruciating for Sasha to experience.
But she also understands the heart and the resilience and the guts of Sasha Banks. Charlotte knows that.
But in the mind of the queen, Sasha Banks should let the medics take her to the ambulance, or maybe not escalate and take her to the hospital.
Well,
you don't compete tonight.
Sasha may be on her way to a hospital if Charlotte gets her way here. Steel chair in hand.
And Sasha staying in it. That baseball slide. And Sasha Banks, the champ, gonna pull out all the stops with another baseball slide. Charlotte bounces off the cell. Sasha flying through the air and pinning Charlotte.
And imagine as much punishment as she just inflicted on Charlotte did Sasha. What did Sasha do to the already damaged lower back of hers?
You're absolutely right. You could see Sasha Banks' feet fly up behind her back. The human body is not meant to bend that way. Couple that with the impact of the cell and Charlotte in between. Watch, look at this.
Oh! And now it's Sasha on the attack.
I think the boss is slowly beginning to realize that it's going to take every risk, every bit of will in her body to retain her championship tonight.
And then some.
Sasha had something in mind, setting up that chair.
Well, Sasha blocks Charlotte with a knee right to the gut. Sasha realizes she goes through that chair, it could be devastating.
Charlotte able to block. Oh! Charlotte tell the boss, you will respect me.
As the queen stands over the boss. As Charlotte said on many occasions, I was born for moments like this.
Trying to make this her night, her moment, but Sasha's got something left. And the boss with the right hands.
Both these ladies are just spent.
I don't know, Byron. I think Charlotte still has plenty left in the tank.
And now face first off the chair.
Oh.
These are the risks I don't think these women thought of before they stepped in the ring. The toll that it could take emotionally and physically. This could ruin Charlotte.
I disagree with you, Corey. They knew exactly what the risk was. They knew how this could shorten their career, but they wanted it so bad.
Oh, no, 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 no! Back first out of the chair! Back first out of the chair!
I think you're right, Byron. The only thing these women are more driven by than the Raw Women's Championship is the ability to write history. And we're witnessing it right now.
The ability to write history and break through any glass ceilings.
Cover for the championship by Charlotte, and Sasha stays in it.
Watch this again.
Making history, but at what cost?
You can hear Sasha screaming, writhing around the ring in agony. I think this is just a perfect example of genetic superiority on behalf of Charlotte. She's bigger, she's stronger, she's faster.
It also has something to do with cheap-shotting Sasha before the match started and then power-bombing through her announce table. And again, working on the injured back of Sasha. Look at the way that Charlotte's got her twisted around this ring post. Not meant to bend that way.
I think the referee should stop this. This is just prolonging the agony of Sasha Banks.
That's the last thing I guarantee you Sasha Banks wants. As much pain and suffering as she is going through right now.
I understand that.
Oh, Sasha's still in it.
Someone has to look out for the well-being of these two superstars. It's not going to be them.
Wow. Like Spider-Man, scaling the wall.
Whoa!
Double knees to Charlotte.
Good grief.
Did you see that?
Charlotte.
Did you feel that?
I saw it. I have no earthly idea how it happened.
But
I definitely saw it.
What resourcefulness from the boss. Watch this again.
This is incredible.
It's like you said, like Spider-Man or Spider-Woman. Catching Charlotte.
Critical moment now, the matchup. Who can make it to their feet first? Who can shift the momentum?
Let's look at this one more time. Sasha adjusting in midair. Oh, that left knee caught Charlotte right in the jaw. Oh, as did that one.
That did too.
Yeah, she didn't miss the first one.
Charlotte into the cell. Guys, you feel the momentum shifting to Sasha a little bit here. You feel the champion starting to take over.
Feel Sasha trying to do whatever she.
Oh, wow. Right into the cell. Pinned Charlotte in the cell.
Whatever she can to make Charlotte feel every ounce of pain.
The double knees.
Every ounce of pain that Charlotte has made Sasha feel.
Pinfall or submission. Only way to win. Look at the impact here. The double knees.
It's almost the shins of Sasha right into the face of Charlotte.
Sasha bringing the attack to Charlotte. Suplex. Looking to pay homage to her hero, the late great Eddie Guerrero.
Lower back somehow holding up. I don't know how Sasha's got enough left.
I don't know how either.
Triple verticals here. And the Eddie chance. Thunder throughout the TD Garden.
A man who inspired her at 10 years old to pursue her dream. To compete inside the ring.
And I guarantee he's looking down with a smile at this matchup. Sasha and Charlotte for the Raw Women's Championship. Sasha Banks, top rope, splash! A la Eddie Guerrero to retain. Charlotte kicked out. What an incredible match.
Think about the flood of emotions. Watch this again. Sasha Banks somehow again.
Wait. Sasha's got the bank statement locked in.
Yeah, bank statement locked in right there. Bank statement's in. Charlotte's trying to make it to the rope. But remember, guys, ropes don't make a break here in Hell in a Cell.
Yeah, but Sasha can barely hold on.
Yeah, Charlotte, though, Wisely sliding out of the ring.
The power advantage of Charlotte comes into play.
Long legs as Charlotte paying dividends there. Sasha, though, knees to the midsection.
Uh-oh.
Not where Charlotte wants to be.
And bye, Charlotte.
Sasha to retain. Charlotte kicks out.
The chair was already mangled from being used before, and Sasha Banks set it up underneath the spine of Charlotte before driving the knees down. Take a look at this.
Nothing Charlotte can do but watch Sasha's knees driving through her rib cage into that steel chair. I don't know if I'm more shocked that Sasha used a steel chair.
No, no, no! Oh my God! Oh my God! Did she hit the steps?
It looked to me like Charlotte.
I think she drove Sasha face first.
Let's see.
Watch this here.
Viewpoint here.
Oh my. Oh, off the steps, face first off the top of the steps.
You hear that thud?
Now what you're looking for?
One can only imagine, but we're about to find out.
God, how much more punishment can Sasha take?
I think we're about to find out.
Oh, God. Oh, no, 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 no.
This is too...
Oh my God, not up top.
This will destroy Sasha.
Is the reward even worth the risk at this point? These two women are gonna destroy one another.
Charlotte looking for a suplex from the top. Sasha able to block. Oh. Charlotte landed right on the apron there and trying to keep her balance.
Oh!
And Charlotte through a table after being kicked by Sasha.
Sasha was able to dodge a bullet there.
Charlotte wasn't. And now could Sasha take advantage? Retain the Raw Women's Championship. Charlotte can't even make it to her feet.
That's good news for Sasha. She can just, there she is, rolling her back in the ring.
Cover by Sasha. Shoulders down at Charlotte at two. And Charlotte is trying to crawl away. And these women, they have gone through a tremendous amount here inside Hell in a Cell. How Sasha's even walking is beyond me.
And look in Sasha's eyes. She's not going to stop until Charlotte feels the exact same pain.
It's a mix of passion, a mix of pride that Sasha's feeling right now that is driving her in this match, and Sasha has another table.
We're about to find out what Sasha Banks is made of. She's in her hometown. They're making history.
Oh, look at this, look at this.
No, 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 no. Oh! No, oh, no!
Did it catch Sasha in the throat or at least the upper collarbones? Either way, extremely effective counter by Charlotte.
Charlotte driving the table into Sasha, pinning her against the cell.
She's giving Charlotte plenty of time to set up whatever she's thinking about.
Sasha slowly making her way back into the ring. I ain't quite sure she knows where she's at. Now she does. Blocks Charlotte face first off the table. Sasha gonna off the table now. Oh. Charlotte caught her.
Oh, into the back again.
Oh, big boot. And now looking for the figure eight. Figure four, got a bridge here.
Sasha trying to leverage herself, trying to grab a hold of that table.
So we're gonna find out what Sasha's made of. Charlotte looking to make the women's champion submit in her own town. Here we go.
Here she goes into the figure eight. Figure eight's in, but Sasha's got a chair. Sasha chair to the hip. Unloading on the hip of Charlotte.
Each successive shot with that chair was harder than the last.
That's one way to break the figure eight.
Both ladies back to their feet. Oh. Charlotte with a short arm. Forearm right there.
Respect me! Respect me!
And Sasha with one of her own. Oh, man.
Both women with the same idea, both connecting.
How bad do you want it? How bad do Charlotte and Sasha Banks want to be women's champion?
Sasha going for the bank statement. Charlotte fighting. Charlotte fighting. Look at the block. She does with a backbreaker again to the bad back of Sasha. And a second time, a relentless attack. Oh, and a third. To win the women's championship, Sasha kicks out.
But barely. Sasha barely able to kick out. Barely able to save her championship.
Something's got to give at some point.
Seeing exhaustion, emotion, downright agony from both women. Who can stay in this?
Charlotte's in control right now. Sasha hasn't moved.
Oh, goodness. Just a little wake-up call from the queen.
Never removed from. And now Charlotte may be looking to put an exclamation point on this attack.
And Sasha, Charlotte was going for a vintage moonsault. Sasha off the table, now blows her back to her own.
Sasha Banks repositioning the table. Is that for her own purposes or just getting it out of the way?
I think she's got something in mind, Corey.
No way. No way will Sasha's back hold up. No way.
Oh, my God. And it didn't hurt.
See, I knew it. I knew it. The lower back is too damaged.
Yeah, just didn't have enough in it. And now Charlotte looking to take advantage.
Oh,
man, on the table.
Ragdolling Banks into the table.
Goodness, Charlotte with a relentless assault. Back first to the table again.
That's a selection. Selection.
Cover, push the leg. Charlotte is the three-time women's champion.
He
The queen has reclaimed her throne.
Charlotte stands tall in the first ever women's Hell in a Cell match.
And then she fixed her crown.
Sasha Banks absorbed every ounce of Charlotte's attack until she could withstand no more.
You disrespected me. You embarrassed me. You embarrassed our whole family. All you had to do was acknowledge me. As the tribal chief, you beat my ass.
But you ain't break my spirit.
Come inside and see my hell.
Want another shot?
This is all about the bloodline.
It's yours, a Hell in a Cell.
Cousin versus cousin.
This time there's going to be real consequences.
For the first time ever, locked inside Hell in a Cell.
The highest stakes that any match has ever had in WWE history.
You only win the match when your opponent says, I quit. There's a reason this structure is called the Devil's Playground. The cell is carnal, wicked, and uncivilized.
Following is a Hell in a Cell match, and it is for the World Heavyweight Championship. Making his way to the ring, weighing in at 323 pounds, is the World Heavyweight Champion, Kane.
For the third time in his illustrious career, Kane will step inside Hell in a Cell, but never have the stakes been higher. And it leads us to the question of this. Will Kane be able to survive tonight? Will Kane be able to head into the next time we are on pay-per-view, still as World Heavyweight Champion? That'll take place later this month, October 24th, 3 weeks from tonight, at the Target Center in Minneapolis, Minnesota, for bragging rights.
You alluded to Kane's two times in the Hell in a Cell. Both those matches totaled just under 20 minutes. Has Kane been thirsting for this opportunity or dreading this opportunity?
And Kane, who will ever forget, 1997, in the first ever Hell in a Cell, Undertaker versus Shawn Michaels, when Undertaker first came face to face with that man, his half-brother Kane.
Well, you're right, you talk about Kane making it to our next pay-per-view as world champion. When you're in a Hell in a Cell match with The Undertaker, you just wonder if you're gonna survive the night, much less the next pay-per-view.
At 299 pounds, The Undertaker!
Ladies and gentlemen, at Night of Champions, Kane thoroughly dominated, dismantled The Undertaker. But as we learned this past Friday night on the season premiere of SmackDown, The Undertaker is back. And Matt Stryker, it is no coincidence that that is coincides with the return of Paul Bearer.
There's a certain motivation that Paul Bearer brings to this devastating relationship between The Undertaker and Kane. Michael, you and I walked around the cell earlier today. It's 100% reinforced United States steel. The Undertaker will use this structure to his full sadistic advantage.
King, this is the 11th time The Undertaker will be involved in a Hell in a Cell match more than anyone in the history of WWE. You more than anyone, because you've been out here for all of those matches, know what this man, the Phenom, is capable of inside this structure.
Well, you're right. I mean, once The Undertaker steps foot inside Hell in a Cell, he becomes a different demon. But tonight, this particular match, this opponent, his brother, Kane, I mean, you can throw all the history out the window. This is going to be different. This is going to be unique.
This is going to be scary.
Yeah.
Paul Bearer out of the Hell in a Cell, and we are underway here. They cannot get that. Well, they couldn't get the cell locked. Door cannot be locked, and Kane unloading on The Undertaker. I don't think this match is officially underway. I never heard the bell ring. They never got the door locked, and Kane finally back into the cell. And it's Kane who goes on the offense early. And perhaps this is no accident. Understanding what the Undertaker's capable of with maneuvers like that. 20 years of destruction for The Undertaker. Looking to continue it tonight.
They are locking the door now. These two superstars are caged inside Hell in a Cell.
And let's not forget what Kane did to The Undertaker back in Memorial Weekend, the matchup officially underway for the World Heavyweight Championship.
All
this
chair
is legal. You can only win via pinfall or submission. But remember, Matt, back at Memorial Day, Kane left his brother in a comatose state, really the culmination of 13 years of planning.
Well, Kane said he saw a weakness in his brother, The Undertaker, when The Undertaker showed some type of compassion to Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania.
And look at Undertaker, the near 300-pound frame, unloading on Kane. And again, this is a different Undertaker than we've witnessed just a couple of weeks ago. Snake eyes. Vintage Undertaker as he takes Kane down.
There you see Paul Bearer viewing the proceedings from outside the cell.
Again, a cover, shoulders down, and a kick out.
Quick backstory, Paul Bearer had an affair with a woman in the bowels of the funeral home in which he lived. The spawn of that forbidden affair was the demon seen Kane.
Undertaker knocked down to his knees after that punch. It was 1991. Oh, and look at Kane now with the chair. Looking to turn the tables on The Undertaker.
But let's humanize this for a moment. I mean, having a brother is the closest The Undertaker's ever come to really fitting in, of being of the flesh. Imagine learning that your only attempt at humanity was revealed to be a lie.
How do you humanize The Undertaker and Kane?
You can't humanize either one of these individuals.
A demon, a monster, admittedly so.
Kane has lived in his bigger, more celebrated brother's shadow for years. That's what this is all about.
And Paul Bearer, the father of destruction, looking on. The man who first got together with The Undertaker in 1991, and they've had their issues over the years, but it seems The Undertaker always gravitates back to Paul Bearer.
Let's not lose sight of the fact that the World's Heavyweight Championship, an accolade that transcends time the same way these two once-in-a-lifetime superstars will do, is hanging in the balance tonight.
Undertaker punishing the World Heavyweight Champion Kane in the early going.
Oh, watch out here.
Just placing Kane's skull, hanging over the steel steps, the target of the boot by the Undertaker.
The Undertaker will use these tools of destruction like no one else has ever been able to utilize such carnage.
You talked about it earlier, Matt, this new improved Hell in a Cell. It's like when Kane or the Undertaker are rammed into the sides of this thing, it's like a death rattle. You can hear that cage rattling.
Yeah, it's now 20 feet high and 5 tons. And to put this in perspective, this is the 11th time Undertaker has participated in this matchup. The closest individual to him, Triple H, who's been involved in 8 Hell in a Cell matches. And look at the reverse by Kane, shoulder first into the steel steps. Over 600 pounds of the humanity battling each other inside this cell.
Kane is arguably the more furious and sadistic of the brothers.
Hey, I wouldn't take anything away from the Undertaker.
Yeah,
Undertaker taught Kane everything he knows.
Not to beg to differ with that. And these two are literally out to
destroy each other. Did you forget what Undertaker did to Mankind inside Hell in a Cell?
Notice now, Kane is focusing the attack what seems to be on the left leg of the Undertaker. That is good strategy.
I mean, it's just, when you see Kane, you saw the look in his eyes. He wants to hurt Undertaker, punish Undertaker.
I think he wants to go further than hurt or punish.
It's jealousy, it's envy, it's betrayal, it's sin. I mean, think of the lifetime that these two have endured.
Well, for 13 years, Kane was in Undertaker's shadow. Never had the opportunity, with the exception of one quick reign, to actually have the Holy Grail. Saw the look of concern on Paul Bearer's face. And what is Kane? Undertaker's leg is lodged between the steel post and the steel steps.
Oh, man. Man. You know, but because the fact that Kane felt he was in the Undertaker's shadow, why is that the Undertaker's fault? I mean, why can't you be proud of your brother? You know, whatever happened to those type feelings. I mean, why does he hold that against his brother? Because his brother was successful?
I don't think it matters. I mean, Kane's demented. That's just the way he's looking at things. But Undertaker's ankle was lodged between the steel post and the steel steps there, and he could have had his ankle fractured there by Kane.
And Kane senses it now, like a smart shark that smells blood in the water. The Undertaker's a wounded animal.
Here, the universe here, the WWE universe, trying to get Undertaker back in this. Just a fury from Kane. Every single movement by Kane, hell bent on destruction.
Remember, no leg, no choke slam, no tombstone.
No anything. No old school. No Hell's Gate. Takes out all the arsenal of the Undertaker. Oh, look at this, look at this. Kane head first.
Well, right about now, in the shape the Undertaker's in, that's all he can do is try to avoid Kane.
That's the Undertaker's sense of survival.
And right, now the Undertaker going to try to use the cell in his favor.
You know, we talked about the leg, but let's not forget, the best pure striker in the history of the WWE is in fact the Undertaker. Those big right hands proving that point.
Undertaker trying to wear Kane down.
I don't know how you wear down a monster. Is it possible?
We're gonna find out.
Perhaps only another monster can. Oh. Wow.
This allows the Undertaker to buy a little bit of time. Still heavily limping around on the injured ankle. How many times have we seen this? Will it still be effective, however? Can the Undertaker make it on that bad leg? And he does! Across the throat.
That's out of instinct, because that had to do as much damage to The Undertaker as it did to Kane.
Now a smile crossing the face of Paul Bearer.
Watch again, it's the right leg that The Undertaker uses for the damage, but he had a push off of the left leg.
Kane, wise strategy.
You can call him demented, you can call him sadistic, but you must call him an evil genius, the world's heavyweight champion, Kane.
Well, look how he won the title. He won Money in the Bank in July and cashed it in on the same night as he preyed on an injured Rey Mysterio.
Yeah, which was legal, but we just witnessed an over 300-pound dropkick straight into the knee of The Undertaker.
Look at Kane, just with every motion and movement, he continues to punish the Phenom.
One more time, look at Kane, precision.
Can you imagine what a victory for Kane would mean tonight? With Paul Bearer coming back, Paul Bearer giving all this confidence to The Undertaker, if Kane could somehow knock The Undertaker off again,
he would shatter the shadow of his brother.
Talk about demented individuals. This is three of a kind.
But again, as we saw Friday night, Matt, the difference and Paul Bearer being back over the past couple of weeks, and The Undertaker's incredible.
Absolutely. I mean, it's a confidence, it's a motivation. There has to be some type of fury in the cob that Paul Bearer brings to The Undertaker's existence.
Oh, look at Kane again. Kane using every part of his body. Now he covers up to prevent himself from being a target of The Undertaker.
Never relinquishes the self-submission hold, though.
Again, continuing to work on the ankle and the leg that was trapped moments ago between the steel post and the steel steps.
Kane's head showing the effect of this.
You think that's going to bother him?
Oh, you don't even know it.
Listen, both these competitors are nearly 7 feet tall, and those long limbs come into play.
Undertaker breaking the hold, however. Numerous punches to the back of the skull.
Hammer fists to the head.
Again, The Undertaker just can't quite get going.
Let's not forget that The Undertaker can take more punishment than any superstar in the WWE.
Well, the man's 18-0. 18-0 in WrestleMania. That should tell you something. Most incredible streak in the history of sports entertainment. No doubt about it.
Well, no doubt. The Undertaker's a big-time player, but, I mean, this match, the implications of this match, the world championship. This is as big as a WrestleMania match for The Undertaker here tonight.
Ooh. And it's about the world championship. It's also about the future of The Undertaker. No. First, it was no holds barred. No. Kane could win tonight inside Hell in a Cell.
A night where the future of the WWE perhaps has been changed forever. What will happen in Hell in a Cell?
Okay, Kane unloading. Undertaker as well.
These two brothers throwing big bombs, just trading. Undertaker down.
Yeah. Oh, here comes Undertaker. That was classic Undertaker. Paul Bearer realizes could be the turning point. He can hardly stand, though.
We're going to test the leg.
Yeah, that's what I talked about earlier. Can he somehow deliver old school really on one leg? The tightrope and the top rope, and again, and by going up top, Undertaker exposed the injured leg. Kane took advantage, and suddenly the demented one is in control again.
That's what I said earlier, sir. Some of these things The Undertaker does, he does them out of instinct, and that was not smart to go up there and give Kane that almost a free shot.
Now it's the devil's favorite demon and the man that Satan calls sir, perilously high above the ring.
Undertaker fighting back, though. Oh, whoa. Man, did you hear that?
How did that not knock The Undertaker unconscious?
The unfortunate son, the world's heavyweight champion, Kane, looking to vanquish his brother forever.
There's been no one in the history of WWE with the resilience, though, of The Undertaker.
So many have tried and so many have failed.
Look at this. Superplex rattling the ring. Over 600 pounds crashing to the ring from that top rope. And now Kane, who loves to go high. The over 300-pound frame.
What a collision. This could do it.
Here, cover here.
Look at this. Undertaker, Hell's Gate. Submission maneuver. Undertaker with a desperation move, but will it work?
Is that left leg 100% in order to lock it in? Undertaker's hands aren't clasped either.
No, he doesn't have the right grip.
Kane, remember, this won't cause a break, but Kane can try to get out of the ring.
He can shift his weight.
Exactly.
Perfect. And his head is also, Kane's head is not really where it should be, where the Undertaker wants it to be.
Oh, the Undertaker's completely lost that grip now.
Yeah, and Kane now using the ropes to his advantage as he finally breaks the hold. Wise move by the champion, but has damage been done?
That Hell's Gate submission, if you're locked in it long enough, you will slip into unconsciousness. Kane needs to get the blood flowing, the oxygen back to his brain so that he can come up with some more sadistic thoughts. Kane better say the Our Father as well as the Shema, because the Undertaker, he's going to need all the help he can get.
Trying to get some blood flowing back in the leg, get some movement back in it. Oh, and down.
Man, did you see that?
This could be the turning point of the match. If one of these men can make it back to his feet, he'll have a distinct advantage with the World Heavyweight Championship up for grabs.
The psychological thriller continues to climb.
This has been a stalemate from the beginning. Undertaker has found an opening.
Oh, no.
Disbelief from the WWE Universe. Off
this!
Undertaker hit the DDT. Can he capitalize? New champion. Cover. Two count. Got him in.
No.
Oh. Near fall for the Undertaker. Again, the leg will be tested. Going for the choke slam on Kane. He got him up and down, and he planted Kane. Off the choke slam. Cover again. Undertaker, and a kick out by Kane at two.
Damn.
Now, what does Undertaker have to do here to put away his brother?
Let's get some circulation back in that leg. Uh-oh.
Undertaker was going for the last ride, and Kane went back to the injured leg. And now it's Kane's turn. Choke slam. Crawls to the cover again. Will he put Undertaker away and retain the championship? No.
Oh, those precious seconds that Kane reeled could have been the difference.
2.5. What a physical battle between these two brothers.
And it's exactly what we expected.
Yeah, there's gonna be nothing pretty about that match. We knew that going in.
Look at that chain just hanging there.
Ominous in the background. All of a sudden, Kane's got the momentum again. Kane is teeing off.
Almost helpless.
This is a lifetime of frustration, a lifetime of jealousy.
Oh, look at this. Undertaker, perhaps playing possum. Kane wins it. Planting Kane. Undertaker, cover. New champion, maybe, maybe, no.
Wow. I think you're right. I think the Undertaker almost was trying to sucker Kane into that corner. But still, I mean, Undertaker's just, he's hit Kane with everything he's got. The choke slam. And look at this.
Last ride to Kane.
And still, Kane survives.
You see Paul Bearer clutching the wire fence.
And
Undertaker, look at bad leg and all, still able to power Kane up. He was going for the tombstone. Kane countered into the tombstone pile driver. Is he going to connect? He goes, and he does. Tombstone pile driver. Kane going to take out his brother. He'll kick out at 2.5. How did the Undertaker kick out of the tombstone?
Snap, and he did snap.
Hey, the official is not. He's unconscious. And
I have no earthly idea why Kane would do that other than just. He just snapped out of frustration, yeah.
Now you see the training staff down here helping the official.
The open door has allowed Paul Bearer to slip inside the Hell in the Cell.
Now we're going to see what kind of effect Paul Bearer has on The Undertaker. Uh-oh.
Well, we may see what kind of effect Kane will have on Paul Bearer.
The father of Kane.
Yeah, where's Paul Bearer going to go?
Should not be in there. He should have been in there from the get-go.
Well, Paul being forced into the ring as Kane stalks him.
Well, Undertaker's going to be no help. Is he trying to get to the Undertaker or what?
Have come back. You should have stayed buried. Do you have any idea what I'm gonna do to you? You should have never come back.
Undertaker! Kane doesn't realize into the choke slam! Undertaker with the power of Paul Bearer behind him!
Truly belongs to the devil's favorite son.
And Kane stalking the Undertaker has been fallen by
the bright light
in the urn. And now Kane planting the Undertaker with a thunderous choke slam. Kane retains the championship. Paul Bearer committing the ultimate act of treason.
Here is your winner and still the world heavyweight.
absolute breach of faith by Paul Bearer, but why? Why do this?
The ties that bind?
We have witnessed the ultimate act of treachery. I mean, why would Paul Bearer bring The Undertaker back from the brink of destruction just to destroy him again?
That hurt. Kane is still the world's heavyweight champion. Tons of steel lowers to the floor, engulfing the ring. It is 20 feet from the floor to the roof of this cell. And to Kevin Owens' point that he made earlier on, only the men and women who stepped inside this demonic structure know just how unforgiving it is.
But don't forget, per Shane McMahon, this match is now falls count anywhere. Inside the cell, outside the cell, on top of the cell, on top of the Little Caesars Arena. This thing is gonna get nuts.
Here comes the money.
Here we go.
Here comes the money.
The following contest is a falls count anywhere, Hell in a Cell match. Introducing first, hailing from New York City, weighing in at 240 pounds, Shane McMahon.
Shane McMahon's family at ringside, his wife Marissa, his sons Declan, Kenyon, and Rogan, here to watch the Hell in a Cell match, the third one that Shane McMahon will enter.
I can tell you that is a very, very bold move by Shane McMahon to have his beloved family at ringside. But if there's one thing that can drive a man to do superhuman things, it's family. And Shane O'Mac is fighting for the McMahon name tonight.
You hit the nail on the head, Corey. That is the motivation. Pure fuel for that man, Shane McMahon, fighting for the name McMahon.
Detroit that Shane McMahon returned to the WWE, the old Joe Louis Arena. What will this chapter hold?
And his opponent from Marieville, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 266 pounds, Kevin Owens!
And again, the Hell in a Cell is designed to contain the competitors. There will be a decision here in this match, but Shane McMahon, as commissioner, has made his own rules, adding the falls count anywhere stipulation to this matchup against Kevin Owens.
And Shane McMahon's opponent tonight is a depraved, truculent Kevin Owens, a man who says people like him go to heaven, but that's because they're afraid that Kevin Owens might take over hell.
Braves the false count anywhere stipulation. Who does that favor, Owens or Shane?
Listen, I've known of and about Kevin Owens for a long time, and Kevin will stop at absolutely nothing
to have his hand raised in victory. And you heard Sami Zayn mention in recent weeks, even he has never seen this side of Kevin Owens. Kevin is sick. He has lost his mind. What, Byron? Disagree with me.
Owens is hesitating. He can't even get enough gumption to get inside Hell in a Cell.
Byron, I gotta disagree with you. I don't think any man or woman steps into this cell without trepidation, but Shane McMahon and Kevin Owens already are outside the Hell in a Cell.
The bell rang, the match is official. Falls count anywhere.
That is exactly what Shane McMahon had to do. Shane has to be the aggressor here. Catch Kevin Owens off guard.
And look at Shane McMahon, those strong strikes. Such a diverse MMA background for Shane McMahon.
Extensive training with world-renowned Muay Thai kickboxer Phil Nurse. Paying off for Shane McMahon.
And watch this, breaking down Kevin Owens here along the barricade.
This is exactly what we expected, a downright street fight.
And Kevin Owens able to bring Shane McMahon away from him for a moment, but again, Shane again with these punches.
Shane has landed a lot of strikes, but Kevin Owens was throwing some bombs, but Shane now drops KO first.
And took out the legs of Kevin Owens. Shane launched into the steel. And now Kevin Owens tossing Shane McMahon.
This is the environment Shane wanted. He wanted no barriers.
Oh, wait a minute. Up on the barrier, look at Shane! Oh.
Shane McMahon knows no fear. Will take every risk necessary to eliminate Kevin Owens.
Never before has one man made things so personal for Shane McMahon.
And a sunshine kick there from Shane McMahon.
I don't think I've ever, it looked like Owens was gonna climb into the cage as a respite. No one's ever climbed into Hell in a Cell.
They're just trying to get away from Shane McMahon.
Owens holding the door shut.
And remember, there's no count outs and no disqualifications. False count anywhere here.
Screw you! Piece of gold!
Shane McMahon just kicked the steel fencing into the face.
Nothing is going to come between Shane McMahon and Kevin Owens here tonight inside Hell in a Cell.
And now Shane watching the official lock the door. Shane wants it locked. No escape for Kevin Owens. And a pump kick right in the face.
Shane into the steel.
Kevin Owens was able to weather the early emotional storm from Shane and is now executing his own plan.
But Kevin Owens launching Shane McMahon one more time.
Yeah, you're right, Corey. Shane McMahon needed to use that emotion, but now Kevin Owens in full control.
Remember what Owens said earlier tonight? I am going to grind Shane McMahon.
Wait.
Take a good look at Daddy! Take a good look at Daddy!
Owens is grinding the face of Shane McMahon into the cell, just feet in front of his children.
We've seen Owens embrace this new level of sadistic, barbaric behavior in the last couple weeks.
Kevin Owens right on the back of the neck.
Byron,
of Shane
I'm telling you, if you follow Kevin's history far enough, there is no length KO won't go to have his hand raised. Period.
Into the steel stairs.
I don't know if the world.
Did you get a good shot?
I don't know if the world has witnessed.
Come on, Shane! Do it for your kids! Do it for your dad!
Out of the match and Mike Larry in the steel when Shane McMahon. Kevin Owens said it earlier tonight, the Hell in a Cell is going to be my ally.
Kevin Owens is one of the most sadistic individuals we've ever seen in WWE. And I'm certain for the past few weeks, Kevin Owens has stayed up all night, lost sleep, imagining depraved ways to hurt Shane McMahon inside Hell in a Cell.
Face of Kevin Owens with evil intentions in mind.
And again, this is all legal in the Hell in a Cell.
What a kick.
And look at Shane lashing out here at Kevin Owens. Shane knows all about the Hell in a Cell, has been inside it before, has done incredible things on and on top of the Hell in a Cell. Knows what it'll take to defeat a man like Kevin Owens.
This is so deeply personal, this rivalry, so rancorous. What is Owens willing to do to finish Shane? We don't know.
Owens has made it clear. He feels like Shane McMahon is the root of all the negative events that have taken place in his career over the last couple months.
Oh, and a boot right on the side of the face, and Shane McMahon down here, and Kevin Owens in full command here in this Hell in a Cell match. And Kevin Owens follows it up with a senton here. And looking for a pinfall, and it falls count anywhere in a kick out.
And I think what's got to be going through the mind of Shane McMahon right now
is
that emotion will only get you so far. Shane McMahon is the commissioner. Kevin Owens is a world-class WWE superstar week after week. Emotion brought Shane here, but I think Kevin's well better equipped to finish it.
Oh, and a headbutt there by Kevin Owens.
To that point, there is a locker room full of superstars extremely interested in the outcome of this match because, look, depending on what happens to Shane McMahon, their careers could be severely affected.
Uh-oh.
Kevin Owens with McMahon right in his sights.
Clear the deck.
Cannonball! And now Owens dragging Shane McMahon back in towards the middle of the ring. Cover and a kick out.
Don't wave your little finger at me. I should be your role model.
Once again, Kevin Owens speaking directly to the family, the children of Shane McMahon. We talked about the motivating factor that Shane's family is for him at ringside. You could make the argument that they're also a motivating factor for Kevin Owens.
They absolutely are, Byron, but this is a different Kevin Owens. This is just a sick, sadistic, malevolent maniac.
Up to the top rope here, Kevin Owens. Remember what he did to Mr. McMahon. Oh, man! And the senton, nobody home. Shane got the knees up.
Yeah, but Shane clutching at his right knee might have done just as much damage to Shane as it did to Kevin.
And Kevin Owens came crashing down. And Shane McMahon could be in a bad spot here. Watch this.
It's a desperation move by Shane, but nearly 270 pounds of Kevin Owens right down on Shane's knees.
And a point of the knee right into the spine there of Kevin Owens.
Shane at least temporarily buying himself a reprieve from the onslaught of Owens.
And coming back here, look at this, with the lefts and rights here is Shane McMahon backing up Kevin Owens into the corner, nowhere for KO to go.
Shane treating Kevin Owens like a heavy bag.
You know Shane will never give up.
And Shane with the elbow. And Shane right back to his usual ways.
And Shane got himself a second wind.
And in with the left and a right. And Shane, there's a forceful kick there to Kevin Owens in the elbow again. Shane with a DDT.
Whoa.
Spiking Kevin Owens into the mat. Shane McMahon now putting Kevin Owens right where he wants him. It's up to your imagination what you can do here inside Hell in a Cell.
Well, Shane McMahon wants to punish Kevin Owens. This isn't about wins and losses. This is about settling a rivalry.
Wait a minute, up to the top. Shane McMahon shooting star press and he missed.
What happens when emotion gets the best of you? Shane wanted to just punish Kevin. It could have cost himself big.
And look at Kevin Owens. Knows he just avoided catastrophe. And now Owens going up to the top.
And now Owens looking to inflict a little catastrophe of his own on the head of Shane McMahon.
Kevin Owens looking to take off here within the cell. And the splash to Shane McMahon.
It could be all over here.
Here on Shane, and Shane able to kick out.
The same monstrous frog splash that Kevin Owens delivered to Mr. McMahon, Shane's father. The same frog splash that got us in this predicament.
This was before this. Watch this. A tremendous miss by Shane McMahon. Kevin Owens able to get out of the way. Look at the height that Shane McMahon got, and then the sudden impact.
Hey, credit Shane McMahon for going for the home run, for taking the ultimate risk.
Yeah, but here's a grand slam right there. And notice, after the delivery of the frog splash, Shane McMahon just barely squirms out. There was no authority behind that escape.
This is Hell in a Cell here live in Detroit. Kevin Owens and Shane McMahon locked inside the Hell in a Cell.
Oh, Owens could be thinking to pop up powerbomb. Oh, my God.
Look at Shane.
Shane McMahon's got an armbar.
Shane got away from it in a triangle. Going for the triangle here on Kevin Owens.
Can Shane complete the triangle? He needs to pass Kevin Owens' arm under Kevin's chin.
It's got Kevin Owens down to the mat here. Could Kevin Owens tap out to Shane McMahon?
This is a desperation submission, but Shane doesn't have it fully applied. Kevin Owens still able to fight.
And Kevin Owens, look at Kevin Owens. Remember, there's no disqualifications here, so Kevin Owens has got to break free of Shane McMahon.
That was great, great ring awareness by Kevin Owens. Using the rope to create a little separation.
Oh, and Shane again, out. And again, out on the apron now. Shane McMahon's got Kevin Owens all wrapped up. And again, it doesn't have the triangle in completely here on Owens.
Oh, no. Desperation powerbomb onto the steel ring stairs.
Did you hear the thud of Shane McMahon's body?
I felt the vibration here at ringside, Byron.
And now Kevin Owens falls count anywhere here on Shane and gets the shoulder up. That's where both these men have to be so careful. You've got to be aware at all times, anywhere, anytime here in this match.
We've seen Shane bounce back before and show incredible resiliency, but I don't know how you bounce back from that.
Listen, you have to remember, this match was the brainchild of Mr. McMahon. Shane McMahon sentenced Kevin Owens to hell in a cell.
Why are you making me do this? Huh? Why? Why?
And you can hear Kevin asking Shane, why did you make me do this?
It's twisted logic from Kevin Owens.
It's not twisted, Byron. Kevin Owens like a wild animal that's been forced into a cage.
Yeah, Shane has barely moved since receiving the powerbomb.
Looking for now.
And Kevin Owens with a table.
We saw this past week on SmackDown Live, Kevin Owens powerbombing Shane McMahon through a table in the arena. Could we see a repeat of history? Or could we see worse?
I might opt for worse.
And look at Owens as complete control here with Shane McMahon. Shane could be at the mercy here of Kevin Owens. I don't know if he'll get any.
Oh, no.
Shane is out on the table here.
Owens is foaming at the mouth like some sort of sadistic animal.
Don't do this.
No, Kevin with a cannonball through the table. Shane avoided a nasty outcome. Cover here, and Owens got his shoulder off the floor.
A one-handed cover, literally. Watch this again.
Look at the impact. Kevin Owens looking for the cannonball. only finds the table. The table just disintegrates.
Watch one more time.
Shane McMahon just dodged the
pole. Look at Shane.
Shane's got a half of the table in hand. Smashing it over the back of Owens.
Whatever weapon is available.
By any means necessary for both men in this match. Shane McMahon again with the table.
Shane swinging for the fences down on the spine of Kevin Owens.
Oh boy. A calling card for Shane McMahon over the years. Kevin Owens and his own tricks from underneath the ring, and now Shane McMahon with his own turn. For all the punishment that Kevin Owens was enjoying putting on Shane McMahon, Shane has turned it around in just as short a time.
Which is remarkable in its own right.
This is all about vengeance for Shane McMahon. Shane looking to avenge Mr. McMahon, what Kevin Owens did to the chairman of the company and Shane's father. Shane executes what we all think he's gonna try. He will certainly avenge it. Listen, after everything that Shane has endured in this match, I think it's insane to attempt this. This is as high risk as it gets. High risk, high reward, or it could be disastrous for Shane.
How far are you willing to go? What are you willing to do for your family? Shane McMahon up on the top rope. Across the ring, coast to coast!
Shane's hurt too, but coast to coast, drop kick the trash can, almost threw Kevin Owens.
Is this the fatal blow? Is this what Shane McMahon had to do?
And look at Kevin. Kevin Owens is motionless, and now Shane McMahon trying to turn him over on his back, and Kevin Owens, foot on the rope. The official is going to allow it.
How? How in the world?
Let's take another look at this coast-to-coast drop kick. On target. Shane McMahon executes the cover, and right... Guys, I gotta be honest with you. I think the referee got caught up in the emotion of the moment. That should not have been a rope break. Kevin Owens should not have been able to stop the pinfall with a foot on the rope. Understandably, emotions running high.
An unusual false count anywhere match within Hell in a Cell, but I don't know if Shane McMahon is thinking about inside the Hell in a Cell, Byron. You saw that glance.
Shane McMahon has always been an outside the box thinker.
Open the door.
Why on earth does Shane want the door open? Kevin Owens is inside the ring. I guess when you're the commissioner, you can make your own rules. Shane McMahon has both covers.
Are you kidding me?
And look at Shane McMahon.
Why in the hell is Shane McMahon trying to leave the cell?
I don't know.
Kevin's issue is with Kevin Owens. I'm sorry, Shane's issue is with Kevin Owens, who is in the center of the ring.
And Kevin Owens has barely moved back in the center. Why not end it here?
He's desperate, Eddie. Trying to...
Oh, no.
Well, whatever it is, Shane has in mind. We're one step closer to finding out.
I'm starting to wonder if Shane knows what he has in mind.
Shane with the trash can.
I guess it's abundantly clear. The one thing we do know Shane has in mind, and that's revenge.
revenge and the pain and suffering of Kevin Owens.
Reducing the trash can to just crumpled steel.
Owens now staggering out of the cell. I mean, I don't know if this is what Kevin wants to do.
And remember, this is a false count anywhere match. There is no safe haven for either of these men in this match.
Ooh. Ooh. Shane once again firing off.
Oh no. And it looked like a low blow there by Kevin Owens. It's all legal. Face first into the diamond plate.
No count out, no disqualification, falls count anywhere. And that rule, or lack thereof, just came back to haunt the commissioner.
Listen to this.
Just imagine the pain that is radiating throughout the bodies of both Shane McMahon and Kevin Owens. All the punishment these two have inflicted upon each other.
Oh, and Kevin Owens.
Oh man!
Owens almost catatonic. It's almost an eerie calm in the eyes of Kevin Owens. The more depraved he gets, the more destructive Owens becomes, the more relaxed in a way.
Same look we saw after Owens assaulted Mr. McMahon, the same look we saw last week after Owens attacked Shane McMahon.
And now Shane McMahon is at the hands of Kevin Owens outside of the Hell in a Cell.
Look at this. Owens trying to tear and grind the flesh off of Shane McMahon's face.
Stop, Shane! You're all right, Shane. You're not open.
Owens now just standing on the neck.
Oh my God.
Whoa, McMahon, guys, be on the lookout.
Oh. Oh, and just smash it, the television monitor across Shane McMahon.
Shane's got nothing left. All right, now this is turning into Kevin Owens' playground.
Shane.
Just like Kevin did to Mr. McMahon. Now, what is Kevin thinking right now?
Something immensely destructive to the body of Shane McMahon.
Kevin Owens up on the barricade. Kevin Owens staring down at Shane McMahon.
Kevin Owens is not thinking. Kevin Owens is not thinking sanely right now.
You're right, Byron. Kevin Owens is completely out of his mind.
Kevin Owens is climbing the Hell in a Cell. There's 5 tons of steel. Kevin Owens is scaling it.
Shane McMahon, in the meantime, has not moved an inch.
There is no question. Kevin Owens is looking to end Shane McMahon. To
oh my God, he's on the top. Owens is on top of the cell.
Kevin Owens is 20 feet in the air on top of the Hell in a Cell.
You ask yourself what lengths Kevin Owens is willing to go to. You're about to find out.
My God.
Someone get the EMTs ready. Someone, this is not going to end well.
Think twice about this, Kevin. Think about what you're about to do.
Oh, no, no. This is Shane's livelihood. This is Kevin Owens' career right here. Shane's family is here watching this.
Thank God, it looks like Owens may be having some reservations.
Kevin Owens can't will himself to do it.
I think it's
probably the smartest thing.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
Where the hell is Shane McMahon going?
A place he knows all too well, the top of Hell in a Cell.
Shane doesn't even know where he's at right now. What the hell is he doing climbing a 20-foot steel structure like this?
Only thing Shane McMahon knows is that he's still got a pulse to fight.
I think Owens is probably going to change all that. Someone needs to get these guys off the damn cell.
Oh, and look at Kevin Owens. Shane is hanging off the cell. Kevin Owens is trying to get Shane off of the cell. Oh, my God. And Shane's holding on by a hand. And look at Shane. Shane is trying to battle to the top of the cell.
This is insane. This is absolutely insane.
Shane McMahon and Kevin Owens on the roof of the cell.
We know from history only bad, bad things happen on top of Hell in a Cell.
Shane and Owens.
Here we go
on top of the cell.
It's a hockey fight on top of Hell in a Cell.
Oh, God.
I'm praying that cage holds. That's nearly 500 pounds of humanity crashing down onto the steel mesh on top of the cell.
I watch this right into the chain link of the steel. Ask Mick Foley just how damn dangerous this is.
These two want to maim one another.
Oh, no.
God.
And again, Owens off of the links of the cell.
Well, Shane McMahon condemned Kevin Owens to Hell in a Cell. This is teetering very, very closely to a death sentence for Kevin Owens.
Shane could drive him on the descent to hell.
It was Shane McMahon for that matter.
Somehow, Owens and Shane battle on 20 feet in the air on top of the cell.
No.
This is insane.
Oh, God. Suplex.
Guys, the top of this cage is flexing. I'm telling you right now, this is not going to end well. These guys could crash right through the top of this cell.
It's clear, Corey. Neither Shane McMahon or Kevin Owens is thinking with a sane.
I know they don't care, Byron, but we're watching two human beings.
I'm as nervous as you are right now.
Something has to give here on top of the cell.
Let's hope it's not the cell.
Shane back up to his feet to meet Kevin Owens.
Kevin Owens to the throat of Shane McMahon.
I can't believe this.
Oh. And every one of these collisions with the cell, you hold your breath.
No.
Please no, Kevin.
Oh, God.
Atmosphere inside this building is it's just become eerie. Everyone's holding their breath with every motion, every movement both of these stars make.
Just feel like you're teetering on the brink of disaster.
Oh.
The Cell cannot hit. No.
No, Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens going for a powerbomb on Shane.
It looked like Owens' ankle clipped one of the support beams.
This is what it's come to. Kevin Owens and Shane McMahon fighting on top of Hell in a Cell.
Think about the punishment these two have dished out in this match. Still inching towards each other, still battling through.
Oh no, oh no. Shane fighting his way out of it. Looked like. Okay. Yeah. I think Owens was trying to get Shane up for the powerbomb, but.
Oh. These guys are getting real close to the edge.
And oh no.
Powerbomb!
Oh my God. Enough.
I thought for sure that was the end of Shane McMahon.
One more time here, watch it, Shane. We can hear him bounce off of the steel.
I don't know whether you thank modern engineering or God that the top of the Cell held up after that. I'm speechless as to what we're witnessing right now.
Nothing else to say.
Whoa, what's going on through that next mind? What in the world could be next for Kevin Owens?
God! Shane just put on the brakes, trying to survive.
God.
Kevin Owens said he was going to throw Shane off the Cell. I didn't think he actually meant he was going to do it.
Oh, and Shane trying to take out a knee here. And again, these two just throwing themselves at each other.
God. You know, the WWE Universe might not like it, but thank God for a little sanity from Kevin Owens.
I agree with you.
Shane's not letting him go.
Shane's got a hold of Kevin Owens. And Owens is trying to get down here off of the Cell. And Shane McMahon in pursuit here of Kevin Owens. This is precarious here, to say the least.
Precarious? This is damn deadly.
On the side of the Cell here. And look at Shane. Both men about 10 feet down here on the Cell. And Shane, shots to the kidneys here of Kevin Owens.
This is about the craziest thing I've ever seen.
Oh, my God. Kevin Owens, face first, bounce off the... No.
Oh my God!
Shit. The EMTs are out here, obviously. Shane McMahon just sent Kevin Owens crashing 10 feet, just exploded the ringside announce the table.
Watch this. And again. Kevin Owens' body just obliterated the Spanish announce table. Watch.
And again, you don't have to like.
Come on. Kevin Owens may be seriously hurt.
EMTs.
Come on.
Shane's still got a pin. He's going to pin Kevin Owens. Shane, it's over. Just pin him. He's not moving.
I mean, this got him.
Kevin Owens is a lifeless heap, and Shane McMahon is still moving forward.
You said it before, Corey. This is more than just earning a win here. This is about ensuring that your opponent does not walk after tonight.
I shudder to think what is going through the mind of Shane McMahon right now. Listen, guys, I get it. I understand defending your family and your father and your family name, but the fight is over. Kevin Owens can't move.
Oh.
Kevin Owens has a family too, damn it.
Payback for his father.
This isn't payback, Tom. Shane McMahon wants to make sure Kevin Owens never competes again.
No,
Shane McMahon is once again going to the top of the Hell in a Cell.
Can the ref, get somebody, get him off there. Come on.
And again, Kevin Owens is out here on the table.
Yeah, Shane, think about tomorrow. Think about your family. Think about your health.
Well, Shane McMahon's the commissioner. Obviously, the official showed a little leeway.
He's on top of the cell. This is all that Shane McMahon's been thinking about. He's seeing red right now.
Come on, no, Shane. No, no. Think about it, Shane.
Shane.
Don't.
Shane, come on now.
No.
Shane.
Oh, no. Damn it.
Shane, oh my God.
What the hell? Where the hell's Kevin Owens go? Oh my God. Sami Zayn!
Sami Zayn just saved Kevin Owens!
What in the hell is going on?
Why did Sami do that?
They're bringing out the backboard here for Shane McMahon, who just launched himself 20 feet off the cell. Listen, Shane is not moving. How bad is it for Shane McMahon?
This could be worse than we ever imagined.
Again, they're getting out the backboard here for Shane.
Oh, my God.
And the EMTs are trying to check on Shane.
What is Sami doing?
What are you doing? Oh, wait, this match is continuing. Are you kidding me? It's false count anywhere.
What did Sami Zayn do? What is Sami Zayn thinking? What just happened here? Shane is hurt. Shane is hurt bad.
Shane McMahon is hurt. Kevin Owens is hurt. I didn't even know if Kevin Owens is aware of what the hell just happened.
I'm having a real hard time digesting what we've just seen.
I cannot explain why Sami Zayn is out here.
I mean, if you saw the look on the face of Kevin Owens, I don't think he has any idea what Sami Zayn was doing out here either.
The EMTs are trying to stabilize Shane McMahon here. They put the neck brace on him. They're trying to get him on the backboard. Frankly, the same help is needed for Kevin Owens after this.
This is a real bad situation for Shane McMahon.
And watch this one more time. Shane McMahon is already completely off the cell.
Sami saved Kevin Owens.
And one more time here.
Watch the bottom of your screen.
Kevin Owens.
Watch that Sami Zayn right there. Watch him.
Sami Zayn just pulls Kevin Owens at the last second off of the table. And look,
it's a better angle right here.
Look at Sami Zayn here.
I don't get it. I don't understand.
Shane McMahon, I mean, that could have been the end of Shane McMahon.
Shane McMahon is seriously hurt.
This isn't over until I say it's over.
Drew McIntyre still has hell to pay.
My title and my legacy on the line, I'm not sending you to purgatory.
Welcome to my hell. Come inside and see me.
It is Randy Orton challenging Drew McIntyre for the WWE title inside the demonic hell in a cell.
Randy Orton gets set to take on Daniel Bryan. The cell will enclose the ring, imprison these men, with Shawn Michaels, the special guest referee, inside.
Shawn Michaels is guaranteed that we will have a new WWE champion tonight.
And the cage door has now been locked by the officials. You win via pinfall or submission. Orton and Bryan one more time for the WWE Championship, which is here at ringside.
Obviously, no disqualification, no count out.
And Daniel Bryan and Randy Orton gonna slug it out to start things off.
That does not favor Daniel Bryan.
Not at all, and Randy
Orton.
You don't
need to get in a slugfest, especially not inside Hell in a Cell with Randy Orton.
Randy Orton knows every nook and cranny inside the cell. And Daniel Bryan runs into power slam by Randy Orton. Daniel Bryan getting Orton caught up top rope. Now Daniel Bryan going to go up high. Whoa, just a drop kick. Knocks Orton off his feet. Daniel Bryan said that he has pride and he has honor. It was all about making a living in this business when he first started, but now his goals have changed. Success makes you better. You want to be champion. His crowning achievement, he said, would be beating Orton tonight inside Hell in a Cell. Orton with a drop kick right on the button.
A little scouting's going on by the Viper.
Yeah, you can't get too fancy.
Randy Orton again, forearm in the face of Bryan. Remember, these two men have headlined pay-per-views over the past couple of months. They know each other so well.
Randy Orton looks quite at home in there.
Yeah! Now Orton, midsection of Bryan on the top ropes. Randy Orton simply said to Daniel Bryan, I am better than you.
Randy Orton certainly believes that. Triple H believes that. The authority believes that.
Randy Orton guaranteed that he'd be WWE champion tonight. And Daniel Bryan again.
But Daniel Bryan has made a career out of proving people wrong about him.
Michael's asking Daniel Bryan, and with Shawn Michaels, who trained this young man, Daniel Bryan. Randy Orton again to the ribs in midsection. And Orton's out. Bryan goes right off the cell.
Welcome to Hell in a Cell, Daniel.
Hear that cell rattle. That impact.
Daniel Bryan will not go down without a fight in this matchup.
Listen to this.
He's come a long way as Randy Orton sent Bryan into the steel steps. And again, Orton knows every part of this cell.
Randy Orton, as you said, no stranger to this cell. He will be one of the first to use it at every opportunity as his ally.
Well, he's called the Apex Predator for a reason.
He wants to make this cell Daniel Bryan's worst enemy.
Daniel Bryan's a great competitor. You know he's not going to quit, but he's just against the face of the WWE.
Daniel Bryan, that steel steps right off the shoulder of Bryan.
It's all legal.
Shawn Michaels is over there checking on Daniel Bryan, making sure he's okay as Randy Orton tosses away the hardware.
Steps exactly where he wants him.
And he has the pace, Randy does, exactly where he wants him.
You're right. This is what he envisioned. That's the way he wanted this match to go. He's just grinding the head and ears of Daniel Bryan in that steel cell.
Complete malice from Orton.
Watch it.
Oh, Bryan releases it. It's over. It's over first. Oh. Into the steps that he set up, and now Daniel Bryan looks to regroup. WWE fans trying to will Daniel Bryan on.
Yes, yes, yes. Watch this reversal.
Now Bryan, the kicks that he's made famous. And now it's Bryan using the cell to his advantage.
Daniel Bryan's a quick learner.
Oh, wow.
First into those, he thought the cell was bad. He was introduced head first to those steel steps.
Don't bring out something you don't want to get hit with.
And here's Daniel Bryan for the cover for the championship. Shawn Michaels in position and a kick out by Randy Orton. Daniel Bryan has come a long way since 1999 when he first trained at Far West Rodeo in San Antonio, Texas, under the tutelage of Shawn Michaels, making $25 to $30 a night. When asked about Shawn Michaels and asked about Daniel Bryan in those days, Shawn Michaels said it was all about cardio, cardio, cardio. Daniel Bryan in incredible shape.
As is Randy Orton.
Nobody's ever disputed that. Randy Orton is one of the best of all time.
And it's not Randy Orton's fault that he's got a great pedigree.
Randy Orton
is a third generation superstar.
He's won 7 WWE championships. Daniel Bryan has Orton exactly where he wants him. Oh, Bryan!
What do you say, Randy? What do you say? No.
Bryan looking to wear down Randy. Saved himself there, but not there. Orton, and he bounced off the sell as he came over the top rope.
That drop kick. Flip Randy Orton right over the top. Now here comes
Daniel Bryan. Oh, and Orton goes slamming into the cell.
Bryan goes.
And this is the pace that Bryan wants now. Again, Orton. And now it's Bryan punishing Orton. The tenacity, the drive to be the best. And Daniel Bryan, though, went to the well once too often. Head first off the cell as Orton sidestepped.
Not good if you're Daniel Bryan.
Oh. Watch this.
Randy Orton. Oh.
Certainly not going to give Daniel Bryan any time to recuperate.
Oh no! Orton usually does this in the middle of the ring, not outside like that! Bryan buckling!
Let's go back one more time and look at Daniel Bryan crash and burn right here. Look at that cell.
Randy Orton has Bryan right where he wants him. The slow dissection of Bryan by the Viper. And now Randy Orton covered. Hook to the leg. Shawn Michaels has to dive into position. Number one trend in the world continues to be hashtag Hell in a Cell. The world talking about this event tonight. Our main event, Orton and Bryan for the vacated WWE Championship. Shawn Michaels voted in as special guest referee by a record-setting vote on the WWE app by you, the WWE Universe.
Randy Orton feeling so confident right now that he's just literally taking his time, having his way with Daniel Bryan, doing absolutely anything he pleases.
We saw Bryan pick up the pace a little earlier, King, but this pace right here.
Oh,
Randy Orton lost.
He's the bike.
Oh, man! Vicious headbutts!
Oh. This crowd, they gotta be careful with this. It's Randy Orton just delivering more and more punishment.
Yeah, and the crowd's gonna make him do it.
Exactly, he's mocking the crowd.
Well, the crowd's being very, very disrespectful to Randy Orton.
Please.
Randy Bryan top rope up over the top. Looked like he was going for a sunset flip. Oh, Randy Orton, man!
Powerbomb, he turned it into a powerbomb.
Great counter by Bryan. Can he take advantage,
power
though?
Powerbomb off that second rope.
Orton is hurting.
Daniel Bryan's trying to get a cover here.
Daniel Bryan has taken some abuse.
Remember, normally the referee would be counting at this juncture, but no count outs, no disqualifications.
Not inside that cell.
Pinfall or submission, we're going to have a winner tonight. Shawn Michaels guaranteed it.
Oh,
wow. Turning it up.
This is unbelievable. I'm not talking because I want to hear the impact. Both superstars giving as good as they get.
Daniel Bryan. Yes. Here we go now. Perhaps a little shift in momentum. Could this be the turning point of the match for Bryan? Orton's dominated. Is it Daniel Bryan's time now?
Maybe getting that second win here. There he comes.
Oh, this is that tenacity we talk about in the heart of this kid. Everything he's fought through to get to this moment. Everything that Triple H and company have put him through for the past couple of months. Daniel Bryan looking to feed off that emotion right here. Oh. Randy Orton taking off the top rope.
And Triple H is the one that put this match together, by the way. He's the one that gave Daniel Bryan this opportunity.
Yeah, he's such a giving man. Daniel Bryan, top rope. Randy Orton in trouble.
There it goes.
Look at Bryan.
There he comes.
Headbutt connecting. Is it enough for Bryan to win the championship? Inside leg hook and Orton at two.
All that bashing you two do at Triple H. Remember, he's the one that set up this match for Hell in a Cell and gave the WWE Universe a chance to choose the referee. I would call that best for business.
I mean, I can tell you this about Triple H. I bet he almost had apoplexy at that point. That was almost a three count. Daniel Bryan was almost the face of the WWE and the WWE champion.
Can you imagine Stephanie McMahon watching this?
Whoa.
Randy Orton, we're going to roll up Bryan here. Is it enough to win the championship? Daniel Bryan looks to count out into the S-lock.
Looking for the S-lock, remember.
Can he get it locked off?
Pinfall or submission. The S-lock is locked in. And Randy Orton trying to get back to his feet to alleviate the pressure here. Randy Orton trying to do what he can. Remember here, Randy Orton with the rope, but he can't force a break. There's no disqualification, so the Randy Orton, you hear Shawn Michaels yelling there, I don't have to break it.
He lifts up to his fight with him and squirms out of that yes lock.
John Mavis with the back bar.
And now it's Daniel Bryan taking advantage of the Hell in a Cell.
Randy Orton bouncing off and being sent right back in.
And now it's Daniel Bryan with a mean streak.
Little turnabout, fair play.
Unforgiving. Steel making its mark on Orton. Oh, man!
Remember, you can use all the toys you want inside the cell.
Things Orton said about him. He's not the guy.
What's he gonna do with all these chairs?
Whatever he wants.
I understand that. What is it?
As if that cell was not dangerous enough.
Randy Orton.
The eyes.
Now it's Randy Orton with a chair, and he begins the attack on Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan gonna rue the day, putting that many chairs in the ring as Randy Orton. Orton cover for the WWE Championship and a kick out at two.
Stephanie McMahon has had a hiccup.
Another chair.
Wow. And again, the vicious Viper. Is it enough? And Bryan again kicks out.
Steel cell. Now these steel chairs.
Hey, John, it was the words of Stephanie McMahon that brought this Randy Orton out. Brought Orton out of his shell. The old Orton.
Yeah, isn't it great that he is? I love it, Randy Orton.
And now Orton again, off another chair to the back, looks to win it. Bryan again kicks out. His kid continues to stay in it.
He continues to stay in it for the moment.
then how much more of this kind of physical abuse can Daniel Bryan stand? How much could anybody take?
Building a bonfire.
I'd like to see the metal burn. As Randy Orton continues to stack chairs middle of the ring.
He gets hot enough, it will. Whatever he wants, Michael, I'll give you the same answer.
Oh, no.
What do you think he's got in mind?
Oh, no. Randy Orton.
Wow.
You got to be kidding me. No.
Man, is this what the authority has driven the Viper to?
And Daniel Bryan realizing that the match hangs in the balance here, fighting with all he's got. And now Daniel Bryan up top. Randy Orton stunned for a moment. Oh, and down goes Bryan. And Orton gonna try it again. Randy Orton gonna try it again.
This isn't good.
This isn't good. You gotta be kidding me! God! Even the referee, Shawn Michaels, felt that one. Shawn is powerless to do anything. He's just got to count the 1, 2, 3 here for Randy Orton. Maybe the championship, and Bryan again stays in it.
He's kicking out.
That's down the street.
Uh-oh. Focus on this match. Oh! DDT by Orton.
Here, words between Shawn Michaels and
Triple H. This is it, John. Hey,
look at this. What is he doing?
He's gotten into him.
Screaming at Shawn to do this. Do your job. What is he doing? That's what he's doing.
Shawn saying, let me do it. Now Randy Orton going for the RKO on Daniel Bryan. And Randy Orton shoved into Michaels inadvertently by Daniel Bryan.
Shawn, you all right? Shawn, are you all right?
Triple H screaming at Shawn. Shawn was looking back at Triple H when he
turned right into
the collision occurred, and now Triple H ordering the official to open the cell. You see the man behind Triple H. That's Dr. Sampson. Yeah, he's a ringside doctor. Daniel Bryan. Bryan exploded with a knee to the skull. This should be over, but there's no official. And Daniel Bryan's got Orton pinned.
Shawn, you gotta get up and count. You gotta get up and count. Shawn, come on. Come on, Shawn. You gotta get up and count. You gotta get up and count.
Hey, Shawn. You okay?
I'm okay.
Oh,
Daniel,
oh my God, Daniel Bryan!
O'Brien had had enough!
And new WWE Champion, Randy Orton.
I'll tell you what just happened. Randy Orton is the WWE Champion and the face of this company. That's what just happened.
I mean, Daniel Bryan took out the COO Triple H.
And I don't.
Is that the cause of Michael's Sweet Chin Music? To Daniel Bryan?
Well, I know that Sean saw Daniel Bryan put that knee right in the face of Triple H.
And the face.
Is that what caused Shawn Michaels to?
It doesn't matter. The face of the WWE, Randy Orton, is rightfully the WWE champion.
What an ugly way to end a terrific match tonight and a terrific effort by Daniel Bryan.
You disrespected me. You embarrassed me. You embarrassed our whole family. All you had to do was acknowledge me. As the tribal chief, you beat my ass.
But you ain't break my spirit.
Want another shot?
This is all about the bloodline.
It's yours at Hell in a Cell.
Cousin versus cousin.
This time there's going to be real consequences.
For the first time ever, locked inside Hell in a Cell.
The highest stakes that any match has ever had in WWE history.
You only win the match when your opponent says, I quit.
Introducing the challenger. From Boston, Massachusetts, Sasha Banks! And her opponent, she is the Raw Women's Champion, the Man, Becky Lynch!
Here we go, guys. Only way you win, pinfall, submission, nowhere to escape. And the Hell in a Cell now is being lowered. The cell designed to torture, as we heard, designed to contain. Nowhere for Banks to run. Lynch versus Banks. Man versus boss. Champion versus blueprint. What a win! Oh, Sasha Banks right off the bat, right into the champion. And look at Banks go now.
The cell is even down.
No, and don't get caught underneath that cell. That could be terrible.
Banks getting right on top of the champion. And wait a minute. Banks getting to the outside with Becky Lynch.
I don't really understand what she's thinking here.
I'll tell you what she's thinking, King. She's trying to bypass the cell.
Well, we know that's not going to work. That's not going to happen.
And now
the cell is completely lowering now.
The cell is completely being lowered.
And Becky and Sasha Banks are not inside.
Talk about a blueprint king. I mean, Sasha Banks is coming with a game plan. Is the door for a minute was open. You can hear the WWE Universe trying to rally the man, but the boss taking it right to Lynch.
You see the official there with that heavy metal chain in his hand. They want to get him inside, and then they're going to bar and lock that. There's that chain. They're going to lock that door if they can get. Oh, Becky's in trouble already, big time.
Five-time champion.
Well, you saw what this is all about. You saw Sasha Banks take Becky and ram her head first into this steel cage.
But King, look at Becky Lynch pulling herself up.
That's the mentality you have to have if you're stepping into a cage, getting locked into a set.
Wait a minute. Oh! And Becky Lynch turning things around in a hurry. Cage door into the face, and now both women inside the cage. Both women inside Hell in a Cell.
Talk about the cell being a weapon. She deployed the door as a weapon right there.
Oh, and Becky Lynch has been waiting all week. She said on Monday there'd be nowhere for Sasha Banks to run once the Hell in a Cell door is shut and locked.
And it's getting that way right now.
And finally, we are getting officially underway here in Sacramento.
Watch out now.
What's she thinking here?
Oh!
Come on, give me
well, guys, I think that's part of this Hell in a Cell.
Everything is legal. And now Becky Lynch.
Sasha Banks, no! Man, look at her crush her ribs.
Becky Lynch, an uppercut. Taking it right to Sasha Banks. Well, you thought this would play into the advantage of Sasha Banks, King, but right now, the man certainly has cranked up the aggression.
Yeah, I don't know if the referee should even try to get that chain away from her or what.
But again, because the chain, the door has not been securely locked to the cell.
Oh man, look out.
It's like a cheese grater, that fence, that mesh.
Becky Lynch has never met a fight she didn't want. She told the locker room to bring their A game.
And it's been said before, when it's flesh against steel, steel wins every time.
And look at Becky Lynch, the man, the Raw Women's Champion. She's gonna lock the cell door herself.
And she's gonna do it on her terms.
Think she's getting overtime pay for this?
Lynch said Sasha Banks made it personal. Well, she said tonight she's gonna make it painful, and what a kick by Sasha Banks.
Watch out, watch out.
And now again into the steel goes Lynch.
That's what we're talking about.
And now Banks, repeated rights. Raw Women's Championship means so much to both these women. And spine first goes Sasha Banks.
Guys, as you can see, there's no way to prepare yourself for this type of match. What? Oh, don't tell me. As if the Hell in a Cell is not weapon enough. Tables?
King, we said anything goes inside Hell in a Cell.
I know.
Becky has been waiting to have Banks trapped. And now just, what's going through the mind of the man? Whoa!
She didn't see that coming.
Sasha finding an old friend in that steel chair.
And you can just see some of the welt starting to form both the bodies of Banks and Lynch through the first moments of this Hell in a Cell matchup. So now what's on the mind of the blueprint?
And there's no telling, but I'm sure it's not going to be good.
Man,
don't turn your back in this match for a minute. Look out!
The old equalizer for Becky Lynch.
You almost have to have some kind of sick creativity when you step into these walls.
Yeah, I'm sure they've sat for hours thinking about, what can I do? How can I make this unique? How can I make this special? And how can I do the most damage to my opponent? Watch this.
Not only watch it, guys, listen to the impact. Boom! How hard was that chair shot right here in front of us?
Oh, look at
and
this!
Now, wait a minute,
look at
shoulders this. Down, Banks looking for the title and a kick out by Becky Lynch. And one more time, shoulders down again. Another near fall. Sasha Banks looking for a quick one. Is
another
third time
another
the charm. A little more weight and another kick out by the Raw Women's Champion. Is now shoulders
backside,
down.
Backside.
Shoulders down.
No.
Lynch able to kick out, but Banks holding on. Holding on to the arm.
You just have
right
to be
arm.
You have to be ready for absolutely anything in a match like this. I mean, not only in 1 minute is that cell going to be used as a weapon against you. That may now metal chairs, tables, and then you can get beat with a simple roll up if you're not careful.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, we saw the Clash of Champions.
She
Becky Lynch looking
that
for
again.
That disarm her. Instead, oh, Sasha Banks turning things around quickly.
Right in your mouth.
Into the cover for the Raw Women's Championship. And again, Lynch able to kick out at two. Guys, remember it was Sasha Banks who had that disqualification victory over Becky Lynch at Clash of Champions. It was really Becky who accepted the rematch and then wanted to defend it inside Hell in a Cell.
Well, she's getting her wish right now. Here comes that chair again. Look out.
Oh,
missed her.
And now, wait a minute. Looking for the Beck exploder.
I think she was aiming to dump Sasha Banks on that chair, but she missed her. Watch out here.
Measuring it. Oh, bouncing off the Hell in a Cell wall.
See the
with Sasha
of that.
Banks. And again.
Again? Yes! This time Sasha Banks went face first into that hard, that tough and central steel.
And Becky Lynch now just taking a look. A quick kick by Sasha Banks. And again, these two women have quite the rivalry. As Banks,
watch
with Lynch
here.
In her sights.
Into
the ladder goes Becky Lynch.
We've seen Sasha Banks use that meteora before, but look at that one.
Did you see the eyes of Becky Lynch, King? For a moment. And no, again, and again, everything legal.
I'm in shock now after seeing this. Watch this again. This is brutal. I mean, the base of her neck. Ram, watch it. Right in the steel rung of that ladder.
And even look, it looks like it could have hurt Sasha Banks, too.
Definitely Sasha Banks grabbing at her left and right knees, but now Banks looking for the Raw Women's Championship. And again, Lynch able to kick out at two. We got to remember, King, Sasha Banks has been in this environment. She has the experience of competing inside Hell in a Cell in the past.
Yeah, and that is invaluable. I mean, not just the Hell in a Cell, but anything. If you've done it once, you're more prepared to do it again. And for Becky Lynch, as you can see, some of this stuff is coming as...
No! The left arm!
Stop! Oh, my God!
Repeatedly being slammed inside of that cell door.
That doesn't dislocate a shoulder.
Or an elbow. And again, everything legal, everything at Sasha Banks' disposal is legal in this matchup.
Ooh! I had a chance just briefly to speak with Sasha Banks earlier today.
Banks into another cover and another kick out by the man.
You're not going to believe what she told me. I asked her, do you regret these actions, anything that you've done to Becky Lynch before? You know what she told me? She said, my only regret, King, is that I can't sit in the audience and watch myself.
Well, King... To the left hand. And another cover this time by Banks. And another kick up by Becky Lynch. But, you know, King, you think about the damage to the left arm and the hand. That's going to make it hard for Becky Lynch to lock in that disarmor.
Oh, you're right about that. And I'm sure that's what Sasha Banks had in mind. And when that opportunity presented itself, Sasha Banks took it.
And Vic, Sasha Banks wisely leveraging the arms on those pins, just making it that much harder to kick out.
Banks just ripping down the Raw Women's Champion. And Sasha Banks in control. And now King, really, whatever runs through that mind of the boss, she can do anything.
You could say it, that evil mind. She is thinking of anything that she can do more damage to Becky Lynch. Poor Becky's just out of it. Look out now. Wait a minute. Look at this.
And Lynch doing her best to fight back, but relentless is Sasha Banks. Is now Banks again. Knees, shoulders, cover.
That's it.
The title, and Lynch again able to kick out.
How? How is she able to kick out of that?
Are you kidding me?
You see the eyes of the champion.
Oh, my gosh.
And take a look one more time. The impact of the double knees right into a pin, and I don't know how Becky Lynch is able to kick out.
At this point, it's got to be pure instinct.
And again, Sasha Banks going for yet another steel chair.
What is she thinking?
King, you mentioned that evil mind.
Well, she's had to lay awake at night thinking of these tricks. How many chairs are under there? Oh,
Banks said, and now wait a minute, going from behind. Lynch, roll up, shoulders down. A kick out by the boss who didn't let go of the chair. He may have wanted to. What a kick by Lynch.
Yeah, that chair driven right into the chest and sternum there of Sasha Banks.
Look out. Oh! Lynch one step ahead of the challenger. Now the challenger fights back. And now Lynch again, just driving Sasha Banks into that unforgiving steel.
Guys, I don't know. Are they going to be able to survive much more of this? Watch this.
Take a look. Wasn't so much the kick king, it was the nasty landing. Take a look at it one more time. Boom!
Man, man.
WWE Universe trying to rally as they've done all year long. The man, Becky Lynch, pulling herself up, as is the challenger, the boss, Sasha Banks. And ooh, there goes Lynch. Oh, another kick. Look at the combination offense by the champion and right into the post. Left shoulder first went Sasha Banks. And now the boss trying to get out of the way, but there's nowhere.
No.
Backsploder. Backsploder into the cage, into that solid steel of the Hell in a Cell.
And look at the pain, the agony on the face of Sasha Banks. But the hits just keep on coming.
Just think about everything these two women have been through so far in this match, and they're still going.
We're gonna find out.
We mentioned the Hell in a Cell was designed to imprison both superstars, nowhere to run, and now both women slugging it out, center of the ring. The man getting the upper hand right now, nice kick by the boss.
Who's gonna be the fiercest female inside the cell?
Onto an open steel chair. And now Becky Lynch follows up again. Banks may be out. Lynch to retain her Raw Women's Championship. On the boss. Left shoulder up at two.
Guys, Lynch
is in disbelief.
I don't blame her. I'm in disbelief from what I've seen so far. Neither of these women have any quit in them. They're refusing to lose.
It's about being the best. It's about being the Raw Women's Champion. As right now, Sasha Banks. Ooh. Nice reversal, but Lynch, who was able to weather the storm early on in this matchup. To the top rope, and oh, what a kick. Almost out of desperation by Banks.
Oh no. Get down from there, Becky. Oh, she caught the chair.
Ooh. Nice counter. And Lynch to the top rope.
Oh, kick.
Lynch into the cover to retain her women's championship. And again, Sasha Banks able to kick out.
Just two, Becky, just two. And look at Sasha Banks. All she's thinking about is immediately going back on the offensive. She's looking under that ring for something else, other kind of weapon.
She could have been looking maybe to crawl away or try to create some space to recover, because Becky Lynch has been taking it to Sasha Banks.
Watch this.
Boom! What a drop kick.
Missile drop kick right into that steel chair.
And then another near fall in this matchup. See Becky Lynch driving in it.
Oh! Oh, no!
Oh! It's Sasha Banks now wearing out the champion with that kendo stick.
You know, it's crazy. All our female superstars here, and especially Becky Lynch, have a tremendous drive to succeed. But it seems like Sasha Banks has a tremendous drive and a desire not to see any other female succeed.
What the heck is going through the mind now of Sasha Banks?
Who knows?
It's like she's in a toy box. She's just having fun at this point.
Oh! Yeah, she's smiling. How do you smile after what these two have been through? Oh, wait a minute.
Lynch pulled the pipes for a moment. And now the champion fighting back. And it's a two. Who tastes those kendo sticks?
This is almost unbelievable, the punishment that these two are inflicting on each other.
What on earth?
Guys, this structure has such an evil reputation, but after tonight, it's gonna be even worse.
Becky Lynch now trying to put together something. Oh! Too much time.
Too long.
Sasha Banks able to paddle back. And repeated forearms. And this is the type of fight, though, Becky Lynch loves. This is the type of fight the man likes.
What?
Sitting
what now?
One after another. Lynch will not be stopped.
We've seen some creative ways to emit punishment.
Wait a minute. What do you do? Look out!
Oh!
Nowhere to go.
Becky Lynch willing to destroy herself.
Watch
to destroy.
Watch it.
Sasha Banks.
It's hard to wrap your mind around the kind of abuse.
Look at that. And again, Banks bouncing off the Hell in a Cell.
Look out!
Now Lynch to the top rope. Leg drop connects to retain it. No!
Unbelievable. Can we see that one more time?
This is
in the chair.
This is that running drop kick. Rocking Sasha Banks, but Banks somehow being able to regroup and.
And that's
Theo, you said it earlier, almost instinctively kicking out of that top rope leg drop.
Absolutely. Becky Lynch knows what it takes to beat Sasha Banks, but this is a different Sasha Banks than she's faced before.
Now she's agreeing. Sounds like the crowd's calling the shots. They want to see that table come into play.
WWE Universe on their feet here in the Golden One Center as the Raw Women's Champion, Becky Lynch.
Well, why you
tried to draw something away from behind. Sasha Banks.
Oh, man.
That backstabber. And Banks back to her feet.
And we've seen her go from that backstabber right into the bank statement, but she clearly has something else in mind.
Yeah, pain, punishment, and to send a message to the man.
Oh. I'm the boss around here. Yeah.
Banks looking back. No doubt, King, what's on the mind of the challenger here tonight.
Oh, no.
It's Sasha Banks and Becky Lynch now trying to fight free. Champion trying to create space. Hurts the challenger.
Oh, she has her. She's got her.
Banks fighting back. Repeated right hands. Breaking the grip of a moment
from
Becky Lynch. And now, looking at Banks just drove Lynch through the table for the Raw Women's Championship.
Got
the butt. Oh, the man kicked out.
Yes, my friend. It is unbelievable.
The man somehow kicked out.
Watch this disbelief.
Again, Sasha Banks driving Becky Lynch through the table.
The table and Becky Lynch broken in half. These fans cannot believe it.
King, you have been a part of, the first ever Hell in a Cell. And right now, you're almost speechless.
Well, you're right. There's only a few people that have sat in this spot with so many Hell in the Cells and seen the main one that I can remember, see Mick Foley thrown off the top of the cell right through our table this close. But what I'm seeing here between Sasha Banks and Becky Lynch is
now Banks.
Unreal.
Banks with that Banks statement almost. Trying to break the hold desperately.
Trying to get her feet outside the ring.
Look at Becky trying to squirm, trying to figure out a way, navigate her way free, and she does.
Hey, don't hang on to this.
Held on to that kendo stick, and right across the back, taking it to the boss.
Wearing out the boss with that kendo stick. Guys, how much more can these two? Female stand.
Presence of mind of Sasha Banks.
Just think, they call her the blueprint, the trap that she set so much at the beginning of the match.
Whether it was by default or by design, take a look at this, King. Whatever it was.
Listen. Impact is unbelievable here. This is And there's more yet to come. Another steel chair.
At what point is it enough?
Well, obviously not yet.
Well, it's not enough until one of these two women walk out of Hell in a Cell, the Raw Women's Champion.
What on earth?
Well, you call her the blueprint, Dio. King, you talk about having a plan. You talk about the evil state.
What is she doing?
Whatever Sasha Banks has drawn up in her mind ahead of this matchup.
You're right. You're right, Vic.
Grief. Oh! Repeated from the boss, wearing down and beating down the Raw Women's Champion.
And just look at the state of Sasha Banks. She's reveling in it.
Well, I can't really remember a beatdown any worse than this that Sasha Banks has ever put on anyone. That's why she's reveling in it. She's in all her glory right now. Then
Banks took a little too much time. And now Becky Lynch.
Well, look what she's made for herself.
Becky Lynch.
No, wait.
All the way to the top.
Wait, look at it. Watch all those chairs back there. Don't do it.
Backsplitter onto a bed of steel. And Lynch now locks in the disarmer. Is Banks going to tap out? Sasha Banks, will she tap? Center of the ring.
She's got the hair.
Had the hair for a moment. Banks trying to figure out a way to get free. And Sasha
Banks
has to tap. Becky Lynch retains the Raw Women's title.
Here is your winner by submission. And still the Raw Women's Champion, the man, Becky Lynch.
Becky proved one thing. She can go to hell and back.
God, that was absolutely amazing. Absolutely amazing. Congratulations, Becky Lynch. What a, I don't even know how to describe it, a well-earned victory. What she had to go through to get her hand raised.
You know, King, I don't know if it was Booker T or Coach on the pre-show that said, when you step inside Hell in a Cell, you have to go to a place not many superstars have, and Becky Lynch certainly went there here tonight in Sacramento.
Well, I don't know. I mean, yes, but you got to hand it to Sasha Banks as well. Sasha Banks took some of the most brutal punishment that I've ever seen dished out.
Well, that was some of the punishment, but Banks would turn things around in this matchup, as Dio pointed out, kind of set up a couple of traps, but in the end.
Boom!
That backsploder onto a bed of steel. One more look at Becky Lynch tossing the boss Sasha Banks, and then would lock in the disarmer. Nowhere for Sasha Banks to go. And while Banks had no choice but to tap out here tonight and inside Hell in a Cell.
Well, Sasha Banks was partly responsible for her own fate. She threw all of those chairs into the ring, and then she wound up getting bounced off of him, driven through him by Becky Lynch.
Take nothing away from Sasha Banks, who certainly had a plan here tonight, as disappointment setting in on the face of Sasha Banks, but standing tall inside Hell in a Cell, Becky Lynch. And tonight, guys, Becky Lynch continued to prove that she is one thing besides champion in the women's division. That is the man.
What a match.
This is a fight to the end. So much animosity, so much anger between these two men. Bray Wyatt constantly telling Reigns, anyone but you, Roman. Reigns strikes first. Reigns has looked extremely competent. He's been extremely competent. Remember, Reigns was the one, guys, who made the challenge. Ooh, to meet inside Hell in a Cell.
Guys, there are many people like Bray Wyatt. When someone like Roman Reigns hits you that hard in the face, it puts a smile on your mug.
Another big right by Roman.
These guys have fought so hard and fought so long. At some point, you just want it over with. Roman Reigns was so close to becoming World Heavyweight Champion a couple times this year until this side traction with Bray Wyatt.
Man. Now Bray taking it right to Roman.
Both these guys throwing bombs early on here.
John, to your point, we saw it moments ago. Roman had the Money in the Bank contract won. Bray wasn't even in the match.
Now Roman, he also looked like at WrestleMania he could have won that match until Seth Rollins cashes in. Then all of that momentum, all that great Royal Rumble that the Roman Reigns had, all that guy gets thrown away when Bray Wyatt targets Roman.
Look at this,
anybody but you.
Another throw by Reigns looking to punish Bray Wyatt.
Yeah, and Roman Reigns just picking up that dead weight of Bray Wyatt, just hurling it across the ring. Look at this.
I'm not sure if you guys noticed the smile that crossed the face of Reigns.
Yeah, I do.
He delivered Bray.
Yeah, and you notice the pace of Roman Reigns. He's not in a hurry. Neither one of these in a hurry. They know this is a fight to the finish.
Well, Roman wants Bray Wyatt to feel every single punch.
Nobody's going anywhere.
You gotta felt that punch down in his shoes.
And Reigns went for the drive-by, and Bray Wyatt rolled out of the way, but Reigns is still able to catch him.
Guys, they're getting dangerously close.
But this time,
Roman Reigns. The sharp edges of that cell.
And Wyatt making the first contact with the cell here tonight. And now Roman Reigns going to take full advantage of it. Face first off the steel.
Right now, at this moment, Bray Wyatt is beginning to realize what he's gotten himself into.
Neither one of you men in your long, illustrious career has ever stepped foot inside Hell in a Cell.
And I'm glad of it.
Thank goodness.
Oh, no!
Been in a lot of cage matches, as has King, but there's nothing like this Hell in a Cell.
Watch this again. Bray Wyatt kicked right into that cell and then thrown face first into it.
It's funny, inside a Hell in a Cell match, that cell can become your best friend and your worst enemy.
As I've sat here at ringside and seen superstars thrown completely off the top of this thing. Look at the top of that cell, how high that is up there.
Oh.
Anything can happen in this structure.
The only thing that limits you is your imagination.
And that's scary when you think about Bray Wyatt.
Well, I know Bray was very imaginative there. A kendo stick right to the face of Reigns.
Where did that come from? Look out!
And just like that, Bray Wyatt's taken over.
You got the whole Wyatt family. There's no telling what Bray had put into that ring. And now it is Bray taking his time. The only thing the referee is there for is to count someone out.
Yeah, no disqualifications, no countouts. It's via pinfall or submission, the only way you win the match.
To do as much damage to your opponent as you possibly can or want to.
Oh my goodness.
Man. In the rib cage.
Roman trying to fight back.
Kendo stick had to take a lot of fight out of Roman Reigns. Oh, there's another shot to the kidneys.
It just wears you down, doesn't it, King?
Wears you down. I mean, it could break your ribs.
That's what it's designed to do.
Well, if Roman Reigns
To your point, Michael, if his ribs aren't broken, he's definitely worn down right now.
Look at it. Great dissecting Roman.
With the momentum in this much in Bray Wyatt's favor.
Oh, and now Bray uses the cell to his advantage.
Bray with that kendo stick. I don't know how Roman Reigns is going to be able to turn things around here. Now, wait a minute. Is he looking for more?
No telling what he has under there.
Why not? The kendo stick worked.
Oh, boy. Metal chair. No.
No.
Perverted imagination, guys, that we were talking about earlier. No telling what this mind of Bray Wyatt can come up with to do to Roman Reigns.
No.
Oh, man, Bray. And Roman fighting back. And here comes Reigns. Headbutt from Roman. And Bray just like that, oh man, right through the kendo stick, splitting it in half.
Bray Wyatt is in his element.
He really seems at home, doesn't he?
Bray Wyatt weathered the storm of Roman Reigns and is now simply dissecting Roman.
When we heard Bray Wyatt last week say to Roman Reigns, oh, I'm going to take you to hell. This is obviously what he meant. Look out here.
Roman Reigns using the chair against Bray.
Whoa, baby. And it took his head off.
Be careful what you bring out. It could be used against you.
And now it's Bray that's stunned.
I don't know if Bray Wyatt knows what just happened to him.
But Roman sure does.
Cage rattle.
Yeah, check it out. See what
else. What in the world is Roman looking for?
What else has been put under there?
Maybe Roman put a few things down there as well.
Look at that.
Uh-oh, double kendos.
Huh? What?
And now Bray Wyatt, see, feeling a little fair.
Ow.
Oh, boy. Gonna pay for your sins, Bray. Double special. How good that's got to feel for Reigns.
And I don't even want to imagine how it feels for Bray Wyatt. Wait a minute.
What
more?
Now?
More?
Oh, no.
Count on a table or two being under the WWE ring.
Four toys.
Look at Roman. Look at his smile.
Roman's been waiting for this.
We need two tables.
Oh, he said one ain't enough. We need two tables.
For a long time.
What's he need two for?
Double your pleasure, double your fun.
Hey, Bray Wyatt brought this all upon himself.
Watch out.
Yeah, you're right. It's hard to feel sorry for somebody that.
I hope you guys aren't counting Bray Wyatt out of this thing. This thing is far, far from over.
Oh, I'm not counting anybody out of this.
Look at Bray. Bray threw that table out of the ring. That's exactly what I'd have done.
Watch it. Try by.
Don't leave your head there, though, Bray.
I
Bray Wyatt gonna struggling right now just to get his bearings back.
Roman's got tables set up on either side of the ring.
I had to rattle his brain.
That'd be good with the erector sets when he was a kid.
Watch it, watch it!
Uh-oh, Bray Wyatt.
Oh, he did watch it.
He's trying to send Roman through the table. Oh, no!
Wait a minute, Roman, what are you thinking here? What are you?
This doesn't end well. No, no, don't do this.
Are you kidding me? Not off the apron!
Oh, no, you're right. I think Bray Wyatt came to his senses and saw, what is he about to do to me? Oh, look out!
Roman planted through the table by Wyatt! Now, what impact! Bone-jarring impact! Watch this.
This is incredible.
Oh, Roman is just spiked. He was spiked by Bray Wyatt. Wow.
This is awesome. Unless you're Roman Reigns.
Well, if Bray wants to finish this, he has to get Roman back in the ring.
He's doing it.
He's able to do it. And now Bray looking to finally end this chapter.
That's it.
And Reigns with the shoulder.
Oh no, you know what's
and
coming here.
And Bray gonna continue to punish Roman right back to the ribs.
That's gonna hurt those ribs and back.
Cover again by Bray Wyatt, kick out. The ribs that Bray Wyatt first went after with a kendo stick and then drove the small of the back and the ribs through the table.
Roman Reigns took about 20 shots, as you said, Michael, with that kendo stick. The human body is not designed to take that.
What's this?
It's not designed to take this either, guys.
The human body is flattened.
300 pounds.
Need a chalk line around Roman.
Oh, he's trying to get out of harm's way, but he may have put himself in an even worse position here.
Watch out, Roman. Watch out, Roman. Watch out.
Wyatt driving Roman into the cell.
Who's he talking to? Few of those many voices in his head, I'm sure.
And Wyatt continues to punish Reigns.
Roman's head is pinned up against that post.
And he's motionless right now.
Here he comes.
Again, just crushing Reigns.
Roman just took everything he had.
Oh, wow. Man.
Just a kick out of that pinfall. And Bray has landed on him, squashed him in the cage.
And backing up and just coming full speed ahead with all his body weight. With Roman's head up against that steel ring post. Wait a minute, I thought there were only two tables out here.
A new one.
Yep.
Well, Roman has barely moved.
It's probably getting more and more difficult to move.
Can't breathe
if you're Roman Reigns. Oh!
Man, you're right, look at that. Drilled that shin right in Roman's head.
Motionless heap.
Oh, just that knee. I think that knee almost did Roman in. If he's struggling now to get back to his feet, I don't know if that's a wise move.
He's just barely moving right now.
Whoa.
I think I know where this is going, and this is not going to end well, I promise you.
He may break Roman in half here.
Roman is almost helpless at this point.
Bray Wyatt. Roman up on the top rope looking for a suplex. Looking at suplex Reigns through the table. Reigns blocked.
Try again, nope, blocked again.
Oh, and now Reigns with the right hands. And now Wyatt's in trouble, and Wyatt trying to fight out of this. Headbutt again.
Oh, Bray Wyatt's teetering.
Oh, no, 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 no. Look at this.
Timber.
Through the table goes Wyatt. Come
That's got to be it.
Oh, and a kick out by Bray.
How did Bray Wyatt survive that? What's this view? Oh, man. But somehow, Bray Wyatt able to get one of those shoulders up.
Man, what a physical encounter between Reigns and Wyatt.
These two guys are spent.
Exactly what you'd expect in a Hell in a Cell match.
Both these men have been hit by kendo sticks, chairs, bounced off the cell, driven through tables, and they're still going.
Man, that was in like the first 2 minutes of the match. They're still going, but I don't know how.
Roman just trying to dig down deep.
He's having trouble to even get to his feet.
Both these warriors are having trouble just standing up, trying to figure out how to finish off the other.
What a toll this. Hey,
whatever happens now, I've gotten my money's worth.
And now it's Roman gaining the momentum. Sister Abigail, rates reversed, rolls him up, kick out of two. Superman punch.
On the button. Good night, Bray Wyatt.
For the win, inside Hell in a Cell, and a kick out by Wyatt.
You're kidding me. You gotta be kidding me.
Roman can't believe it either, King.
That was an awesome sequence from Reigns, and Wyatt still survived.
That might have been the best sequence that Roman Reigns is capable of putting together tonight. Watch this entire sequence. No, we're never gonna see Sister Abigail. No, a roll up. Follow that roll up with this. Bang! Superman punch.
And Bray still able to kick out.
That Roman had certainly done his homework.
That should have knocked out a bull moose. But somehow Bray Wyatt survived. I don't know if that's a smart move. Ordinarily going outside the ring, you're going out to a little safety, but not in this situation, not in Hell in a Cell.
Now, just like that, though, Bray Wyatt is right back on the attack. Reigns, though, counters.
Watch it!
Through the table!
That's it.
Did you see the back of Bray's head driven through the table off the spear? Reigns sacrificing his body.
Spear! And watch this!
Oh, boom! Right through the table!
Through the table with both bodies!
Look, Roman wasn't just sacrificing his body, he was sacrificing Bray's too.
And both men just collapsing in a heap.
Roman landed on Bray, but took a lot of that brunt himself.
Bray Wyatt may be unconscious.
And he hit real hard.
See it just one more time. I gotta see this one more time. Spear through the table.
Well, you gotta know that Bray Wyatt has a lot to prove tonight as well, maybe as much as Roman.
Look at this. Roman, I think, now realizes Bray Wyatt has not moved. This may be the time for him getting back in the ring.
Well, all the Wyatt families, you know they're watching somewhere, wherever the hell they are. Can Bray Wyatt do it all alone?
Not if Roman has anything to say about it. Crawl into the cover to try to put away this Hell in a Cell match. Bray again with his shoulder. Another near fall for Reigns.
That weird Wyatt family, John. Who knows where they are? Maybe someplace with no electricity.
But you know the pressure that Bray feels as the leader of that family? To walk out of here victorious against Roman Reigns. Look at Roman.
Bray is the leader of that Wyatt family.
Right now, I got a feeling that Roman Reigns is trying to convince himself that he can still do this, that he's still got enough left in the tank to somehow finish Bray Wyatt off.
You're right, King. That's half the battle.
What's he going to do?
Roman's gearing up for one last spear.
Oh, no.
Ready to Bray. Bray Wyatt. Sister Abigail. Cover for the win. In the cell and a kick out by Reigns.
Oh, man.
If you're Bray Wyatt right now, frustration sets in.
Frustration?
Disbelief
is what that is.
Sister Abigail right there from Wyatt. How many superstars has Bray Wyatt beat with that move?
And that may be the most emphatic Sister Abigail I've ever seen him deliver. But look at this sick, perverted laugh of his now. What's he laughing at?
Bray Wyatt said he knew he was going to come down to this. These two warriors in this condition, in this moment of this matchup.
What's he laughing at? What's wrong with him?
How long you got, King?
Oh, man. Oh, no.
As much to steady himself as he is as a weapon.
This is that.
This is
mental madness at work again.
That's demonic, is what it is. There are evil intentions. Roman has no clue what he's about to hit.
This is about to get unpleasant to watch.
Roman is out. He's out of it.
You asked for this.
Oh, and Roman fighting out of it. Bray told Roman, you asked for this. And now it's Bray Wyatt who's getting it. What a match. Roman Reigns asked for it. I'm not sure he'd realize he had to walk through hell to get it, but he certainly did.
King, after everything these two men have been through over the past number of months, you had to expect it was going to end like this.
Well, I think anyone had to expect it was going to be out of the ordinary, but I don't know if you could expect what we saw in this match. I mean, everything. These two men tried to completely destroy each other. What's this? Oh, my gosh. How Roman Reigns survived that, I'll never know. And that wasn't all. The demonic mind of Bray Wyatt was outsmarted. Roman Reigns, what's this? What's this fear? Oh! That's one of those matches, JBL, where it's like mercifully comes to an end.
Bray said, anybody but you, Roman. But I think only Roman could have done this. Wow.
Guys, I think we in the universe have just witnessed a classic.
Never walk out of Hell in a Cell the same.
Tonight,
you simply survive.
Inside Hell in a Cell, Roman Reigns expels the Bray Wyatt curse.
You disrespected me. You embarrassed me. You embarrassed our whole family. All you had to do was acknowledge me as the tribal chief. You beat my ass.
but you ain't break my spirit. Come inside
and see my hell. Want another shot?
This is all about the bloodline.
It's yours, a Hell in a Cell.
Cousin versus cousin.
This time there's going to be real consequences.
For the first time ever, locked inside Hell in a Cell.
The highest stakes that any match has ever had in WWE history.
You only win the match when your opponent says, I quit. The first of two Hell in a Cell matchups here tonight.
Listen, both of these teams came into this match expecting and prepared to raise the bar, raise the level of competition, and make history. This one is going to be unforgettable.
This already, both teams leaving the ring, going underneath.
Not wasting any time.
Looking for some implements of destruction.
What the?
Look at, Big E's got a chain in his hand. Look at New Day. Kofi Kingston, or rather, Xavier Woods has got a kendo stick.
It's all legal.
Let's go. Oh, right out of the gate. Here we go, inside Hell in a Cell.
These four men looking to destroy one another in the name of being called tag team champions.
Oh, and Big E! Big E so deadly serious. Oh, before this match got started. And now the Usos and Xavier Woods right in to help out E.
Doom and gloom of biblical proportions. What a prophecy from Big E.
Xavier Woods. Oh! Big connection.
Look on the face of Xavier says it all.
Remember, guys, this is the contractual rematch for the Usos after the Sin City Street Fight last month. If they lose this match, they won't get another opportunity at the tag team titles.
Oh, boy.
As New Day are champs.
I have a feeling the team that doesn't win this match is going to spend a couple nights in the hospital.
Watch this. Working together. Look at this. Steel chain around the fist, right in the face.
Talk about taking it to another level if you're the New Day.
Tag around the cover here, rather, and a kick out.
Big E is all business tonight.
And frankly, so is Xavier Woods. Xavier Woods came out of the gates hot in this match.
Oh, no, Big E thinking some kind of thoughts, feeling some kind of way.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, and Big E, the first to collide into the steel.
A 300-pounder right into the steel structure.
And Xavier Woods sends Jey Uso.
Uh-oh.
And now Jimmy over the top.
Oh, my goodness. Jimmy Uso just crushed Xavier Woods between his own body and the steel mesh of the cell.
Watch this one more time. Jimmy Uso, no concern for his own well-being. Taking down Woods.
Listen, you got two teams as familiar with one another as these are. Innovation becomes necessity.
Oh, and Big E with the spear into the steel. The Hell in a Cell buckles.
He might have knocked himself out.
You know, this cell is meant to contain all these superstars, but that's not to say this cell can inflict unimaginable damage on those who step inside.
So many incredible matchups between these two teams. They said it this past week on SmackDown Live. No matter where we are, we put on a show. One more look at this. Big E full force into the steel.
Keep it all out on the table.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh! Francesca 2000 Turbo is involved and broken.
Francesca might need first aid.
I think it's safe to say this is the first time a trombone's ever been used inside Hell in a Cell.
It's a night of firsts.
You think about the 20-year history of Hell in a Cell.
Hey, whoa. Wait a minute.
Uh-oh.
Another one?
This is a strategically placed plethora of trombones.
Hey, you gotta come prepared, man. Credit the New Day. Will this be Francesca number three?
I think Jey Uso's about to find out. And they're gonna need a new one. How confident Xavier Woods is just strutting around the ring.
Listen, as much as New Day have a penchant for having fun, being ridiculous, we don't need more cowbell.
There's always room for cowbell. Come on.
Oh,
wrestling call, Bruce Dickinson.
Oh! And Jey Uso getting beat down with a cowbell here in Detroit. What else?
Oh, there was a lot. Oh.
You gotta be kidding me.
And a gong.
Why not? There's a bunch of octopus here in Detroit. How have we not seen that yet?
Only a few minutes into the match.
What's up, Bears?
Oh!
Points for the New Day for creativity and a Hell in a Cell.
It's done, it's a wrap.
And Xavier Woods is already calling to end this matchup. Big E setting up Jey Uso here. Going up to the top.
Watch
the chair at Xavier. Now Big E able to, Coleman, a super kick. Collapsing into the cover for the titles and a kick out.
Well, here come the Usos. Jimmy and Jey were able to weather the early storm.
Well, look
the
at this
musical
again.
Attack.
Watch the chair.
Boom.
With the chair. Just tossed it. And then Big E would get caught by the super kick.
Yeah, I agree with you, Corey. Man, it seemed like New Day was poised to close this thing out. And just like that, it's advantage Usos.
Wait a minute, now the kendo stick launched into Jey Uso.
Uh-oh.
Got a trio of kendo sticks and a...
Oh! Batter up for the Usos. And now Big E at the hands of a two-on-one attack here from the Usos.
All the New Day tap into their barbaric nature. Now we're seeing the same from the Usos.
We saw the New Day walk out as champs from a street fight, a match that the Usos picked, but this is totally different.
There's nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. And now it looks like the New Day's instruments of destruction are about to be used against them.
The unicorn kendo stick.
It was a judgian blast from the Usos. All rise.
And now Xavier Woods outside the ring. The Usos turn their attention towards Woods.
Yeah, yes, they come. Shoot.
Again, the Hell in a Cell line is
wailing away on Xavier.
You see this?
That's street mentality, the Usos swing on sight. Don't stop swinging until it's over.
Kobe's helpless on the outside. All he can do is watch.
Hey, watch this, Kobe.
Jimmy has Woods pinned inside with the kendo stick.
He's got to throw the chain link here.
Don't do this.
Wait a minute.
Good night, Woods. Guys, Woods could be hurt bad, physically incapacitated. This is as good as a handicap match from now on to Big E.
Getting a taste of it.
Watch this again. Hello to their Hall of Fame father, Rikishi, knows all about the Hell in a Cell.
Woods' head was forced into a meat grinder.
You're getting a taste of just how bad it can truly get inside the Uso penitentiary.
Yeah, remember, Byron, the New Day asked for this. New Day demanded to defend their titles in this unforgiving structure.
And the Usos, listen, there's no tomorrow. If they don't walk out of here as tag team champions, they might not get another opportunity at the titles for quite some time.
Big E, at this rate, New Day might not walk out at all.
Oh, wait a minute.
Big E, overhead, bound to belly.
And now Big E is starting to find a way back here in this match. And Jimmy Uso, rather, out onto the apron.
Oh, right hand, right on the ear of the powerhouse.
Gosh.
A measured strike there to the muscle of the New Day. And now trying to manipulate Big E. Easier said than done here.
On the apron.
To your point, Tom. And sent into the steel post is Jimmy Uso. Another super kick.
Xavier Woods still trying to recover. Big E is out.
All four of these men have been rocked thus far in this Hell in a Cell match.
Oh! Oh my God! And a backbreaker, it looked like, by
Xavier.
Woods got his knees up just in time.
And Xavier Woods is clutching at his left knee, which is already braced for this matchup.
Woods is willing to put his body in danger for the sake of giving his team the advantage. Watch this again.
Look at this, the power of E driving Uso straight down. Woods sliding in, delivering a knee right to the spine.
That's incredible wherewithal, though, for Xavier to know exactly where he needed to be. Big E alike.
That's how crafty the New Day has become. Now four-time tag team champions. A Big E directing traffic, sending Xavier once again back up to the top turnbuckle. Jimmy Uso is in trouble. Up, up, down, down. This could do it for the New Day. Hook to the inside leg, broken up. And Jey Uso just there in the nick of time to save this matchup for the Usos.
Big E, the first man to his feet, which is somewhat amazing given the punishment that he's endured.
And Big E sending Jey to the outside.
You just sense the toll this match has taken on all four of these men.
And Xavier Woods once again back underneath, collecting even more kendo sticks.
How many kendo sticks are there?
Another uniform one.
You got to come prepared for this kind of matchup.
You're absolutely right. Obviously, the New Day were overly prepared.
Turn him around. Turn him around. Yes. Yes. Turn him around. Turn him around.
Yeah. New Day.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Now,
yeah.
Watch out, E. Watch out, E.
Show him something.
Oh. A little payback in the corner on Jey Uso.
Oh. Yeah. What's up, Uso?
You want to talk about a penitentiary? We're about to put you in jail.
Oh, you going to jail, Uso? You going to jail, Uso?
Look at this.
Oh, wow.
The New Day doing exactly what the Usos did with Xavier Woods
earlier. Smart move.
A kendo stick right across the face.
This is a great strategy.
And lighten up the ribs in the process. Look at the house smart assist by the New Day.
And across the face, it's two on one now.
Uso, no. Uso, no. What's up, Uso?
This is New Day.
Locked inside the Uso penitentiary, Jey finds himself in solitary confinement.
This is what happens when you come into hell in himself.
That's it, baby. I want him.
We're about to find out how vicious, how cruel the New Day can truly be.
We've already gotten a taste of it. I think it's going to get worse.
It was just insult to injury.
Become extraordinarily physical, but it's also...
It is two on one now. I can't stress that enough. It has become a handicap match in the favor of the New Day.
Again, it's all legal and incredibly intelligent strategy by the New Day.
I completely agree with you.
Face first off the steel, and Kofi Kingston on the outside just trying to get in the head of the Usos.
Oh, no.
Xavier Woods just flashing a pretty evil, threatening smile. What does he have in store here?
On top of the steel post, Xavier Woods looking down. Jey Uso got free of those restraints.
They escaped and just averted disaster.
Whoa, wow.
Great agility. Boom!
All for naught, however, for Woods. And Jey Uso, and run over by Big E. Jey Uso was able to get free. Now Jimmy Uso, like a wild man, on the run and caught.
Just ran into that 23-inch bicep of Big E.
Wait a minute, Big E. Oh, and Suguri.
Oh, no. Right onto the shoulders of Jey Uso. What's Jimmy thinking?
Wait a minute.
We're about to find out, Corey.
Jimmy Uso on the run. Oh, sending Big E into the steel.
Look at this tag team maneuver. Big E driven almost through the steel cage.
And Big E driven into one of the solid support beams of the cell and then grinding all the way down the cell. Watch this again.
I'd be surprised if that didn't tear a little flesh off the back of Big E.
And meanwhile, this matchup wears on. Now the Usos have turned the tables. They've got a two-on-one opportunity on Big E.
Big E's a sitting duck.
And a splash from Jay. Jimmy follows suit. Cover here for the tag team titles. Big E's still in it. The New Day is still in this match.
You got to give credit to Big E. No idea how he managed to kick out, how he managed to survive.
Big E's running on adrenaline and instinct alone right now. First, the splash number one. Boom! Here comes the second. And miraculously, Big E endures and escapes before the ref counts three.
This match has been a continuous scene of absolute carnage. Jimmy Uso just eyeing down Big E, where Jey Uso is perhaps seeking more tools to inflict damage.
See Kofi Kingston on the outside trying to shout motivations to his teammate. Oh, no. Not one, but two pairs of handcuffs in the clutches of the Usos.
And the New Day getting a rude introduction to the true Uso penitentiary here at Cy Hell in a Cell.
Well, these handcuffs will be more effective than those kendo sticks, you can rest assured.
Just when you thought these two teams couldn't take it to another level. And again, Big E was right in the focus of the Usos, but how wise is this to take away the powerhouse in Big E? And wait a minute.
Oh. Woods is getting locked up as well.
They're going after both members of the New Day. And Xavier Woods is trying to fight out here. Xavier Woods is trying to get free.
Jey Uso just throwing hands on Woods, who's cuffed up. Jimmy doing work on Big E. Oh, no. Xavier Woods is helpless.
Oh, no. And Xavier Woods is caught up by the chain of the handcuffs here around the steel post.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, no. They're making Kofi Kingston watch this.
Xavier absolutely defenseless, absolutely helpless.
The Usos redefining brutality inside Hell in a Cell.
Oh, and look at Woods. That's all Woods can do.
Fracture Woods' ribs.
And Woods is helpless in this situation.
The Usos care.
Of course the Usos don't care. Jimmy and Jay are happy to deliver this much pain.
I mean, it's getting to the point where it's not just about regaining the tag team titles. It's about making sure the New Day never competes again.
It's never just been about the titles, Byron. It's these two teams wanting to claim supremacy for themselves.
Oh, wait a minute. Six to the outside and a nasty fall, and Big E swatted a kendo stick from Jay.
Oh, no. Look in the eyes of E.
Oh, and Jay. Jay caught here by Big E. You do not want to be the target of Big E in this kind of situation.
I think Big E just snapped.
Big E's seeing red here.
Take him for a ride, son.
Oh, no. Oh, into the cell.
The shell just shifted about 2 feet.
Make him pay, son. Make him pay. Come on, son.
And again. Kofi saying do it again, and Big E exploring the space takes out both Usos.
As a one-man wrecking crew right now in Big E.
Big E coming at the Usos like ED-209 coming after RoboCop.
And now Jimmy Uso tossed inside the ring. The straps are down. Could be game over for the Usos. Big ending! Cover to retain the titles! Shoulders down and a kick out!
Unbelievable!
Went for another super kick, now look at Big E!
Uh-oh. He's got Uso trapped in a stretch muffler submission. Might break Jay's leg.
The Usos tap out here. No, and Jimmy with the kick. And another super kick connects. And now Jimmy and Jay, boom! One more time.
The trifecta, and now the Usos are going for the home run.
And this is how the Usos got the job done at SummerSlam. Remember, now going to the top here. Look at Big E, center of the ring. Double Us! Big E could be done for. Hook to the leg here, broken up by Woods. Woods at the last moment.
Handcuffed and all, Xavier Woods.
Take a look at this, double the impact. Jimmy and Jay soar through the skies of Detroit. Bang! Crash landing on Big E.
And Xavier Woods,
it wasn't so much as a save, it was just Woods diving into the chaos to try to save his partner.
It was desperation, Byron, but it worked.
Now the Usos trying to figure out, what do we have to do next? What do we have to do to put an end to the New Day?
Again, kendo sticks in hand. The Usos look to pick apart Xavier Woods. Look at Woods.
He's trying to grit his teeth and take it.
Standing defiant in front of the Usos. Oh, and a headbutt. And look at Xavier Woods lashing out.
Woods is enraged and still handcuffed.
His hands still cuffed, and he won't back down. And now Jimmy trying to pry Woods off, and Jay in with a kendo stick, hammered away on the ribs.
Wearing the kendo stick out on the body of Xavier Woods.
And from kendo stick to steel chair.
Oh, look at this, Woods defiant, still fighting.
And the Usos poised to inflict more punishment.
Oh, no, no. Woods center of the ring here. And the Usos setting up one more time here. The double Us. Oh, with the steel chair. Cover here by Jay. And the Usos are five-time tag team champions.
Third time did it. And the new SmackDown Tag Team Champions, the Usos.
In a cell has become the Uso Penitentiary.
It was barbaric. It was volatile.
It lived up to the hype is what it did. The two greatest tag teams on SmackDown Live, if not in the entire industry, raising the bar of competition inside the demonic structure.
Xavier Woods down the stretch in Bolden against the challengers here tonight in Detroit would hammer it away on one half of the Usos, but again, it was a two-on-one attack in this situation.
A two-on-one attack that the Usos would use to their advantage, wailing away on a defenseless Xavier Woods.
And give credit where it's due, Woods fought until the bitter end, but the Usos just had too much left in the tank. Jimmy and Jay just wanted to be called supreme, just a little more than New Day tonight.
We saw these two teams tap into the deepest, darkest, most evil parts of their personality just to survive. And in the end, that team would survive and regain the SmackDown Live Tag Team title.
And Kofi Kingston's been allowed into the cell here to check on Big E and Xavier Woods. Take absolutely nothing away from the New Day. They stepped up in this hellish structure.
We know the pride that both of these teams compete with. And after tonight, there is no man that competed that deserves to hang their head in shame. What a battle. There are the closing moments, the final straw. The Usos delivering a double splash through a steel chair and claiming their fifth tag team championship.
These two teams set the tone for what this tag team division is all about.
Once again, the SmackDown Tag Team Division on lock for the Usos.
You gotta give it up for the Usos. You gotta give it up for New Day, but the Usos set out to to reclaim the titles and did exactly that.
Two teams went in, one team leaves as SmackDown Tag Team Champions. Congratulations to Jimmy and Jay, the Usos.